Welcome back, comic book nerds and otakus.
I'm your shoujo webtoon fanatic, Zaria.
I'm your friendly neighborhood game dev, TJ.
And I'm your local potato and video game enjoyer, Gian.
And this is Off Panel. Where we talk...
We're keeping this in the blooper.
We can put it at the end of the episode, I guess, yeah. Oh my gosh.
It's okay, I'm TJ, and all things comic.
Welcome back, comic book nerds and otakus.
I'm your shoujo webtoon fanatic, Saria.
I'm your friendly neighborhood game dad, TJ.
And I'm your local potato and video game enjoyer, Gian.
And this is Off Panel,
where we talk about all things anime,
all things comics,
and take on fun challenges.
Just Off Panel. Yeah, baby! Woo! I guess you can call this our season 2. Welcome back, guys. Welcome back.
New school year.
New school year, new term. New look, I guess.
Yeah, new look, as you can already see.
Yeah. We actually really do have a new look. We have our new way of presenting this video. I hope it's enough. It looks a bit more entertaining for whoever's watching this. But
Yeah, dude, we're all fancy now, thanks to TJ.
The gamer setup.
I really like our new setup.
Yeah, I know, right? It's actually pretty fun.
Yeah, it is really fun. But moving on from that, our first topic of today, I've got something to share with you guys, and Gian has a discussion he wants us to have. So let's get started. First off, we're gonna be talking about two new trailers that came out recently during PlayStation's live stream.
Let's go.
So let's move on over there first. All right, let's go for our first topic. So Insomniac Games has released two new exciting trailers that's gotten Marvel fans like really, really excited for their next games. So first off, as you can see behind us, is the Spider-Man 2 trailer. So I'm really excited about this discussion because among the three of us, we kind of represent like different demographics of people who are interested in this kind of stuff. So me, of course, I'm like really into the comics and like, you know, the other media, of course, that's based off of the comics. Gian, I'm not sure if you are like, you know, really into the comics or stuff, but I do know you're into the other forms of media that come out of comics, like the games and the movies.
I'm not that into the comics. Mm-hmm. I think my dad is though. So.
And then Zaria, of course, is more on the anime side of like, you know, our discussions most of the time. So I'm really excited to hear what you guys what your thoughts are whenever stuff like this drops, and that's why I wanted to talk about this today. So the new Spider-Man 2 trailer dropped. Me, of course, and other like fans are really excited about like the concepts and stuff they're bringing from the comics into the Insomniac game. We really love what they've done with Spider-Man and Spider-Man Miles Morales, so we're excited about these two new games that are coming out. But I wanted to hear you guys. What are your thoughts on this? You know, like, are you interested in playing it, or you know, what do you find cool about it? Is there something that, you know, maybe didn't really interest you when you watched the trailer and stuff like that? So I guess we can start from left to right. So Zaria, maybe you could start us off.
I didn't get to play the first Spider-Man game on the PS4, yeah, but I've seen some clips of it and it looks pretty fun. And when I saw this trailer for the second one, I think it's really interesting that they've decided to add Venom and
Miles.
I think it's pretty interesting, and considering the amount of time they're like giving to still develop it and the way they presented the trailer, I'm hoping that, well, like some people in the comments of the trailer said that we're hoping that there's more extra gameplay to it, like more features, like it's not just a, you know how some sequel games are just like copy paste of the original one, but with a slightly different story like that. They're hoping that it's not like that. Like hoping for more stuff to do in the game, and I'm pretty interested in seeing where this will, like, incorporating that those new characters into the story.
Same. I'm really excited, like, with this, especially since. I believe some people are saying there isn't going to be co-op here. I really hope there is co-op, though, because now that we have two Spideys, like, in the same game.
Oh, yeah, that would make sense. So that would make a lot of sense.
Yeah, right? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We kind of caught, like, a glimpse of how that would be, like, in the opening of Spider-Man Miles Morales, because in the opening part of that game, the first, like, big, like, action sequence is you and you know, the other Spidey.
Oh, yeah.
Fighting the Rhino and a bunch of escaped prisoners. And I thought it was really cool to see, like, how the AI Spidey would, like, you know, move around the field with you and, like, help take down enemies and stuff like that. So I thought it was cool. And, yeah, I'm just like what you said, the comment section said, I'm also really excited to see other new features that they add in. Because the improvements they made from Spider-Man Miles Morales off of the first Spider-Man game on the PS4 were really good, and I really like the new gameplay additions they had when they had Miles. Yeah. So I'm really excited to see what they do with this next one. How about you, Anoushia? How about
you? You know how you said, like, how you asked the question, like, are you interested in this type of game?
Yeah.
Like, before you, like, asked, like, from left to right?
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
It's not that... It's not a question of am I interested in the game. Is do I have the console to play the game?
Oh yes, of course. It's so hard to find a PS5.
It's not just that, but it's like, am I, like, able to get one, like, because in my house, right? The things I get, they have to go through my parents first. Like, if I want something, it goes through my parents. And I don't really ask for much, because I know most of the time they'll say no. I think a PS5 is also on the list of no's. So,
I mean, it's hard to get, and it's expensive. It makes sense.
Okay, say if I had my own job already, right? And I had enough money to buy off of scalpers. Run... and, like, get my money run dry.
Alright.
Would I play this? Yes.
Hell yeah.
I would, because, like, okay, I watched the first one, and I'm also a fan of open world games, and I just loved seeing, like, the way Spider-Man, like, traverses through the whole map.
It's so exciting.
Like, I know there's fast travel too, but, like, why would you when the web slinging is so fun?
Oh, that's true.
It's so, like, exciting.
I think it's so funny as well. It's like you do a fast travel and he takes the train. Why?
I really like the fast travel animations too. It's randomized, so there will, like, be different, like, things he's doing on the train. Sometimes he's just, like, on his phone, and another guy's, like, falling asleep on him, or he's doing tricks for the people while he's on his phone.
Or, you know, he's outside of the train. Anyway, I would definitely want to play this, because when I saw the gameplay for the first one, it was open world. I love that about it. So I just end up wandering off, just like I do with Breath of the Wild and Genshin. Though mostly Breath of the Wild. So I like that about it, and I get to swing around. I get to get distracted by random side quests. And
the side quests are so fun.
And it's fully voiced too, so that's also what I like. And with the addition, I guess, of with this one, right, the new one. If it were co-op, I want to see how fun it is, like, with people messing around with each other.
Yeah. And I want us to be able to hit each other with our own webs.
Yeah, I know, right? That would be funny if, like, you know, because, like, Spider-Man is able to actually stick people onto walls if the web shooter is powerful enough.
Yeah.
Or if they're, like, at max web shooters.
Yeah.
So So like, if they stick to the wall, what if we stick like I'm like, if I play as Boz, what if I stick TJ, who's playing as Pete, then he's like on the wall.
I want friendly fire.
Honestly, that would be really fun, especially if it's let you mess with the physics too. So like, you can throw an enemy at your
TJ. Yeah. That would actually be fun. But even if it weren't co-op. It would be nice to be switching POVs. I don't know. I didn't watch the entirety of Spider-Man Miles Morales.
Yeah, yeah.
But if it's not co-op, I wish it like swaps POVs. Like in one mission you play as like Peter, or in one mission you play as Miles, or you could do the thing like GTA 5 where you could swap between the two at any time.
A lot of people actually want like a if it's not co-op, people would really want a GTA 5 style like gameplay where you can switch between the two of them.
Oh yeah, that would be nice. Yeah.
Yeah, true.
Me personally, because I've had this theory like ever since like the end of ever since we got Spider-Man Miles Morales, and I was like, okay, so we have two Spideys now, right? So the first game had one Spidey, second game now we have two. And then come the third, because like they've been building it up, like we're gonna get Venom, right? And I'm like, yo, wouldn't it be crazy if they let you play as all three of them? You just switch between the Spider-Man Peter, Spider-Man Miles, and then Venom. Because they had an old game called Spider-Man, Ultimate Spider-Man for the PS2, and it had the campaign where you kept switching between Spider-Man and Venom, and I thought it would be really cool if they let you control three different Spider people.
Oh man, that's true. I've heard of that game too, though. It's like it swaps between Spider-Man and Venom.
Yeah. Ultimate Spider-Man was if people aren't praising Spider-Man 2 for the PS2, they're praising Ultimate Spider-Man, because both of them had like really amazing web slinging, and the campaigns were fun, and like the combat's great and stuff like that. So it's like those like two of the games that people keep talking about, like for Spider-Man games.
I don't know how that'll work though, unless they make it so that when you swap to Venom's POV, he's just causing rampage.
That's how they did it in Ultimate Spider-Man. You kill people when you're Venom in that game.
Man, that's it.
They have several animations of Venom like eating civilians, and that's how you stay alive as Venom, because you're constantly dying when you're playing as him. So you have to eat people to survive. I never realized how brutal it was until I played it again like a couple years back.
Oh man.
They didn't hold back at all.
But like, I don't know. Like, say it's like that, right? It would make a lot of sense. But imagine if they like they're like building him up to be the main villain of the story, right?
Yeah.
And before they all joined forces for a bit.
at the end, fight against
him. Isn't Venom, at least in the comic, at least from what I've heard, isn't Venom like an anti-hero?
He is. After like, you know, his whole thing with Spider-Man ended in the comics, he became he had his own series called Venom Lethal Protector, and he was an anti-hero. He's usually an anti-hero, honestly, nowadays, even up to now. He's usually an anti-hero. I think the only time he's a villain is whenever they need another Venom to be an anti-hero, or if they're doing, you know, his origin story again, so he has to be a villain, you know, for a bit.
Yeah, that's true.
I see.
The thing about the trailer, by the way, the one who was talking in a Russian accent.
Yeah.
That's definitely not Eddie Brock. Right?
No, I think that's Kraven the Hunter. I think like it's a foregone conclusion. Like whenever somebody hears that accent in a Spider-Man related thing, people are like, yeah, that's Kraven.
I have no idea who that is.
Oh, Kraven the Hunter, he's like his whole thing is he wants to hunt the strongest animals on Earth, and then after doing that, like, you know, hunting down animals with his bare hands and like, you know, primitive weapons, he's like, I need a bigger challenge. And then he finds out about Spider-Man, so he goes all the way to New York to fist fight Spider-Man or something. Or it's like Spider-Man's his ultimate prey, and he wants to like hunt him down. That's his whole thing.
I see.
Oh man.
That's why in the theory it was like, I don't know, he's looking for a challenge and stuff like that. And then like Venom replies to him, I guess. At least that's how the trailer makes it out.
Huh. I've never associated Venom with anybody else other than Eddie Brock, though. So,
in the comics? He's the most famous. I can't say who Venom is, in this game without spoiling the other two games. So, you know, for the sake of the people watching us, I can't say who Venom is in this game.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks. Don't spoil me either. I haven't finished Nazareth.
But there have been multiple Venoms in the comics. But Eddie Brock is the most famous iteration of it. And honestly, even like with the stuff I know from the past two games, you know, I can't say with 100% certainty who Venom will be in this game or if Venom will switch between multiple people in this game or not.
That's pretty cool, though. Mm-hmm.
But I'll move it on to the next game, the next trailer that they put out.
Let's go.
So we can get to the metagaming discussion. I don't want to run this a bit too long. But anyway, I'm switching it over. Hopefully,
I'll say one last comment though about the thing.
Yeah.
In Before Carnage.
Honestly,
Before
Carnage. You never know. Yeah. Oh, there we go. It's playing the right trailer.
Okay.
Okay, let's go. Next trailer is, of course, the Insomniac Wolverine trailer, which they played this first before the Spider-Man one. So when people like saw the bar and then they saw this guy like drinking, people were like freaking out, is this a Spider-Man game? And then suddenly this part comes up and everyone's
claws.
That was actually really cool.
Yeah, that's, oh my god, that was like such a big surprise for me too. I was like, yes, I was so excited to see like Insomniac tackle other characters. Like I really wanted them to do like a Daredevil game because I think that like that's gameplay wise that would be pretty close to like a Spider-Man game because they have a similar power set and universal system and stuff like that. I was just really excited to see them expand the universe because the Avengers do exist within this uh-huh. universe because Avengers Tower has always been in the New York City that they have in that game, and they have references to other characters. There's even, you can actually see Matt Murdock's like office, like when you swing by Hell's Kitchen in game.
I see. Nice.
So I was really excited to see like these other characters be brought to life by Insomniac Games, and then we got, you know, the Wolverine trailer, and people are like speculating about like, oh, what kind of gameplay it will have, and it's really exciting for us comic book fans, especially since Spider-Man and Wolverine have kind of a close relationship in the comics as well. They're kind of like bros, and like I think it's like really cool like their kind of dynamic, because of course Spider-Man is like the joking guy and Wolverine is like he's pretty serious.
It's like a comedy duo.
It is, right? And they honestly share a lot of, they bond over a lot of like their surprising similarities. Like they both come from like a life of pain and stuff like that, so they kind of relate to each other in that kind of way. And I thought I'm really excited for this because there was this one comic that I saw like going around the internet a while back, and I thought it was like a really sweet moment between the two. So like Wolverine invites Spider-Man to a bar, right? And they get the drinking, and then Spider-Man's confused the whole time, why'd you invite me to drink with you, don't you have like other drinking buddies and stuff like that. And then they get in a bar fight, Wolverine almost kills someone, and then when the clock strikes midnight, they both leave, and Spider-Man's still confused, why'd you invite me, and what was this even for, why'd you ask me to meet you here? And he's like, it was my birthday, and I thought it was like, oh, he just wanted Spider-Man to like hang out with him on his birthday. I thought it was so cute to see it. And then the last line he tells Spidey like at the end of the comic, so he asks like, okay, wait, if it was your birthday, why didn't you invite the other X-Men or stuff like that? And Wolverine was like, you know, the X-Men are like my family, but they don't have any illusions about me, so they know who I am, what kind of person I am, what I do. But you're one of the only people who still like believes I'm a good person and stuff like that. I thought it was really sweet.
That's really nice.
Yeah.
This is the actual Wolverine, right? Like the small one?
Yeah, the small one in the comics. And Wolverine's actually pretty short.
He's shorter than me.
Shorter, yeah. He's 5'3".
He's 3, he's 5'3".
5'3", yeah. So, that's why.
He's taller than you,
I'm really excited for that kind of dynamic. And I wanted to ask your guys' opinion on this, on this trailer. Like, like you guys even have like any kind of opinion on it. I'm not sure if you're fans of Wolverine or stuff like that. I don't know, but I just want to get your opinion on it, man, from like in different perspectives, because I'm coming from a place of like the comics and stuff.
The comics, yeah. Me, I just come from like popular like movies and media about, you know, characters. So my first exposure to Wolverine was Hugh Jackman's Wolverine. Mm. So the idea of a 5'3" Wolverine is weird to me. So, like just imagining, right? Because Spider-Man is canonically, even in most media today, he's 5'10".
Yes.
Right?
Yes. He's almost always 5'10".
It's so weird for me to think about that thing you said.
Tiny Wolverine.
For once, Peter Parker is, it's like bringing a child to a bar. You know.
It just feels
weird to me, because like I assume someone like Wolverine is really tall.
I'm now like imagining Tom Holland with like a tiny Hugh Jackman standing
there. Yeah, I know, right?
Honestly, if you get like a new movie Wolverine, right? Like in the MCU, I want them to get a short actor. I really want them to. Just to see what it'd be like.
I want it to be short but buff.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's actually Wolverine.
The dude's
he's
wide.
He's small and stocky.
The dude's wide, so he looks tall. But when you see him standing next to someone, he's really short.
He's small, yeah.
And he looks even shorter because his usual fighting style is him like crouching, like really close to the ground.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Nice. Well, it seems in this trailer they didn't go for the small one.
We can't really.
Well, then again, he is on the high chair, so.
Yeah, he's just sitting down. All we can see is that he's muscular.
Yeah,
that's true.
Because it's more like a teaser, right?
Yeah, it's a teaser. Yeah, I want to see more in the trailer.
How about and this? Hopefully, what do you have any thoughts on Wolverine or this kind of like story or game? I guess I don't know.
I'm curious to see where it'll go. I want to see if it ties in with Spider-Man so that we can have a small Wolverine.
Small Wolverine. I'm small Wolverine.
We need a camera panel like just looking at him from like a lower angle so he looks really tall, and then it zooms out and like Spider-Man. Him and yeah. Spider-Man is way taller.
It's so weird, right? Because you think like Peter is young and you associate it with like youngish height, like 5'9", 5'10", or 5'7", right? But like you associate Wolverine with someone taller.
Small king, yeah, Wolverine's a small
kid. Yeah, small. And then he's next to a small kid. Like an even smaller kid.
You know, because of his height, there's this thing in the comics that he usually does with the Hulk or the Thing, or Colossus even, where they'll pick him up and then they'll throw him at someone, and it's called the Fastball Special. So they'll throw him at someone and then Wolverine will just like completely eviscerate whoever they throw him at.
Seems about right.
Yeah, even
like throwing your Pokeball.
Yeah, he curls up into a ball and then he just like, crouches on their arm and then they lob him across the room. He's done it with the Hulk, the Thing, She-Hulk, Colossus. Basically, anybody who's like really strong and like really big, they'll throw him.
Yeah, anybody above 7 feet. Yeah, he's a Pokemon.
He is.
Wolverine, I choose you. Oh, you know who's really strong and buff? Ash. You see how he carries? How he carries Pidgeotto.
I'll never get over that. There's like a picture of Ash standing next to Lily from Pokemon Sun and Moon, right? And they're both carrying Pokemon. One of them is on Ash's head and the other one's like in Lily's arms. And both of them weigh like tons. Like a ton or more.
Even one of the bird Pokemon, I don't know if it's Pidgeotto or like the sparrow one.
I believe the Pidgeot.
Yeah.
No, sorry. It was still a Pidgeotto. I don't think it evolved. I mean, it's the one he left in like the forest near some town.
Yeah, it's like, but it was a bird that didn't look heavy, but it was.
Yeah. The Pokemon are deceptively heavy.
Yeah.
Yeah, that ball that Lily carries is like, I don't know, 99.
Yeah, it's almost a ton, right?
Kilograms, I think, or something. Yeah.
it weighs more than me.
She carries it in a bag, right?
That's like 2 GNs right there.
Wait, GN, a ton is 1,000 kilograms, right? Isn't it?
It's 999.
No, but like... No,
you said
there's
two
like,
GNs, you don't weigh a 500
No, because it's like... Because I heard Zarya say it was like 99 kilograms, the Pokemon.
No, it's so 999.
Like,
yeah, I think
oh, 999?
Yeah, okay. She said 999.
I heard 99, and I was like, that's two GNs right there. So, okay, 999 it is.
Wait, you weigh how much? 58?
About 50.
Oh, okay.
I'm still 50. I don't know why.
Man, that's crazy. Are we? We're around the same height, and I weigh 65 kg.
You're slight. No. I think you're noticeably taller.
Am I? It's like 2 inches, dude.
I can't
we're
even
pretty
remember.
Close.
I don't know. When I look up, I don't see the top of your head, so that's how I know.
What? How?
We're almost the same height. It's just 2 inches.
I can see TJ, the top of TJ's head without looking up.
No, I mean.
You mean like
the actual top, not like the top from like looking at, like,
even if we were the same height, you wouldn't see the top of my head because we both be eye level.
No, but like it would be a lot less difficult. anyway,
okay, that's all I wanted.
You
to
just
ask
have to stand at a respectable distance.
Yeah. I'm looking respectfully.
I'm looking at respect.
Oh man. Anyway, let's move on to the next topic.
Anyway,
you're over for your discussion.
Okay, so the thing I wanted to talk about is meta, which is a bad word for some games, or at least for most people that play really, really balanced video games, like Final Fantasy 14 with a free trial that not okay.
I'll critically acclaimed Final Fantasy 14.
You know, like the meta, which is basically a bad word, right? For people that play really, really balanced games like Final Fantasy 14. So let's start with an example, right? Let's start with a not so balanced video game.
Okay.
Where there's a clear difference with how bad characters are compared to, like, for example, this character to this character. You can tell that the like character A is really good and character B is not so good. Let's start with Smash.
Ooh,
let's start with Super Smash Bros. There's a, you know those, you know the, you know those tier lists that people make, right?
Yeah.
You know how in a game like Smash, you can agree that this is valid because you notice that the weaknesses of one character is way worse than the weaknesses of this character. Like Little Mac, for example, my main. Right?
Yeah.
Then you compare it to the top, which is like something like Joker, Pikachu. What does Little Mac have going? He's small, he moves fast, he attacks fast. What does he not have going? He's bad in the air, he sucks at recovery. What does Pikachu have? Small, fast, attacks fast. What does he have over Little Mac? Everything that he lacks. Something like that, right? Something like that.
Yeah, it kind of is. Kinda.
Yeah, okay, Kirby, right?
Kirby.
Even someone like Kirby has visible weaknesses. What does he lack? Some little, like, sometimes he's a bit slow. Like, his movement speed is a bit slow compared to someone like Little Mac. But what does he have over Little Mac?
A recovery. You don't even need to use his recovery.
You can get
Kirby
back
can
on
jump
stage.
All the way back to the stage.
Yeah.
Float. Yeah, right. Yeah. But like, he has multiple jumps, right? Where Little Mac only has one, and his actual recovery goes so far, right?
It's like a slightly taller than his jump, I think.
No, I think it's about the same in the air.
Is
I think
it?
It's about the same.
Bruh.
I think it's about the same, yeah, in the air.
Bruh.
Yeah, right. So obviously there's a huge imbalance, right?
Yeah.
There's a huge imbalance. Now, Let's look at Final Fantasy 14. You see, you got the pictures I sent you.
Oh yeah. Just tell me which ones you want to see first.
Okay. So, let's start with something basic. Let's start with Paladin, the one with the sword and shield. That's complete polar opposite.
Where's
complete
the polar opposite.
Those are definitely not. That's okay. That's Paladin. Let me break this class down to TJ at least.
Break it down.
Because he doesn't really, well, he played, but you know, he didn't get that far. Paladin, arguably the simplest tank to play. Arguably.
Alright.
In, like, when people usually go to, like, tank experts or people who play the game long enough, they want to, like, hey, what's a simple tank so I can learn tanking? They go for Paladin.
Or
what
Warrior.
Or Warrior, right? But we don't have a picture of Warrior. I won't bother sending. Anyway.
Just send one into the top.
Alright, fine, I'll send one. But anyway, Paladin. What does it have going for it? Well, for one, it's simple to play. It's what people would probably lean to if they liked swords and shields, because it's the only class with a sword and shield aesthetically.
It's like the classic knight.
It's the classic knight. So some people would be into that.
I just remembered your Paladin character.
Shut up! Shut up! Shut. Anyway, it's simple, does really respectable damage, arguably, probably second, among the second best among the tanks. It has okay defense, a skill that we call an invulnerability skill. It basically doesn't let the Paladin take any damage. There are little downsides to this class, basically. The only downside is that its invulnerability is the longest out of all the tanks, right?
Like, the longest cooldown.
It's the longest cooldown out of all the tanks. So, as you can see, right, it's pretty all around. It has it has pretty good damage, okay defense, and the best, and arguably the best invulnerability, right? Yeah. Now let's compare it to Dark Knight.
It's the one with the big sword.
It's the first one.
Wait, do you still need the picture of the warrior? No.
Oh, you can put it there now. Okay, Dark Knight.
Where is the warrior with like a Monster Hunter character?
Actually, now that you mention it. Anyway, let's compare it to Dark Knight. Dark Knight has okay damage, depending on who you ask. It does okay damage. If you look at this, if you base it off of actual statistics, arguably the lowest or third lowest damage among the tanks, right? But has the best defense because of one skill. It's not the invulnerable. It's because of its shield that scales off of it. Basically, like, the shield is stronger based on the target's max HP.
Wait, what if you put it on, if he doesn't have a shield?
No. Like, it has an ability that acts as a shield, an in-game shield, not like a weapon shield, like a defense skill. Yeah, like Zhongli, something like that. Imagine like that.
Got it.
Okay. It has arguably the best defense. But its trade-off is its damage and its invulnerability. Where Dubai told you the Paladin takes, like, all it does is it takes zero damage for a really long cooldown.
Yeah.
With Dark Knight, it prevents you, like, it gives you a buff that if you quote-unquote die, you don't actually die, but it only lasts for 10 seconds. Alright, you get that?
It's easier to just tell him what it does. Living Dead.
Okay.
Has 10 seconds. If the Dark Knight's HP hits 0, it will stay at 1. But the Living Dead becomes Walking Dead for 10 seconds. If he's not healed to full HP, he'll die.
Yeah. It's okay if you have a White Mage, because the White Mage can automatically heal to full. But if you don't, it's
still okay.
It's okay, it's just that it takes a lot more. So that's the balance, right? But if you compare the tanks like Paladin and Dark Knight, the damage difference is negligible, and the defense is also pretty alright. Like
Paladin is squishier.
Oh like, yeah, Paladin is squishier, yeah.
A lot.
Mm-hmm, that's true. But like, that's... Okay, Paladin is squishier, but it has like... It has like better damage, right? Dark Knight is not that squishy, but deals slightly less damage. Now show the picture of Gunbreaker. It's the one with like the trench coat.
Why are these all this collection of GN classes?
How did you know I played all tanks? I'm just kidding.
They all look like what you would play. Is this him, right?
Yeah, that's him.
Okay.
Now with Gunbreaker, it is. If I said Paladin is squishier than Dark Knight, Gunbreaker is even squishier. Right.
It's got because
it doesn't pour any of its strengths into its defense. It poured it in its offense.
Yeah.
It deals the highest damage out of all the tanks, but at the cost of its defense. Your offense is your defense because you kill bosses faster. you negate like, future damage.
The Giga Chad Gian class. Oh.
No, I don't. That's not my main. Dark Knight is my.
He shoots himself like Persona 3.
Yeah, his info, like what Zeria said, he does a Persona 3 and drops his. Yeah, he shoots himself. He drops his HP to 1. But then.
He won't take damage.
Yeah, he won't take damage, just like Paladin.
Bruh, that's cool.
Okay, now bring up Warrior since I brought it up, I guess.
The Axe Boy.
Monster Hunter.
Mr. Monster Hunter. Where is he? Wait, where is he?
Is he at the last slide? Because I think he added
to me. I'll switch it out again.
Wasn't he on the last? There we go.
There.
Okay. Now Warrior. He's arguably middle ground. Like, he's probably the second best defense. And the third lowest damage, or the lowest damage, depending on who you ask. If you ask me, he's the lowest damage. No, I'm just kidding. But with Warrior, right? He's a bit of a unique one because his defense lies in healing the damage that he takes in some cases. Yeah, he heals it. He heals the most out of, well. Okay, maybe not the most, but like he. Like healing is a part of his mitigation, where most of the tanks mitigate via damage. Yeah, they take less.
This guy just heals the damage he gets.
Yeah,
bruh.
This guy just heals the damage that he takes.
Nice.
And his defense is comparable to Dark Knight. The closest, I mean.
Okay.
Okay, hang on. I'm gonna look for a photo of the statistics though. Why this is all balanced.
Alright,
hang on.
Just send it while you keep
going. Yeah, I'll send it. Just give me 1 second.
I mean, it's all balanced because the ones with the highest offense have lesser defense, and the ones with the higher defense have lesser offense. And all of their invulnerability skills are, they all do their job. And like, there's even some minor differences in the amount of time that it's up, like Dark Knight and Paladin have 10 seconds. And then the Warrior and Gunbreaker have 8 seconds.
Yeah, and then their cooldowns. Oh yeah, we didn't talk about Warrior's invuln yet. Basically, he just doesn't go below 1 HP. That's it.
For 8 seconds, yeah.
But okay. But the reason why it's really, really good, it's because its cooldown is the it comes off cooldown more than the other invulns. It's the shortest cooldown. Like, it takes 4 minutes for it to be back up. Dark Knight takes 5, Gunbreaker takes 6, and Paladin takes the longest at 7.
Yeah.
Because Paladin's is that good. Anyway, here's the thing I wanted to send. Check it out for a bit.
I'm drop it. Just carry on.
Okay, if you since you see that graph, right?
Yeah.
Even with the weaknesses and strengths I showed you, because in Final Fantasy XIV, the quote unquote meta is DPS. Mm-hmm. So, a class is viable if it does enough. Like, if it does enough damage. That's from what I've seen most of the time.
Yeah.
If you see that chart, that's the DPS chart of all the tanks compared, pit against each other. It's a bit of weird. No, it's okay. I'll keep talking, but like, as you guys will see later. Okay, there. You see that? Okay, Gunbreaker, Paladin, Warrior, Dark Knight. I told Gunbreaker has the weakest defense but the highest damage, and then so on and so forth. But if you look at their bars, they are identical. Their differences are negligible.
Yeah, like 1.5, 1.30.
It's
very close.
It's really small.
Exactly,
well,
right?
So, graph. It's gonna be
disclosed. Yeah, I know, right? Right. Okay. So, compare it. Let's go back to Smash for a sec. If I pit Little Mac against Joker, you know that Joker is winning, right? Like, picking Little Mac.
Joker me
no. That's beside the point. In a tournament, if you pit the best Little Mac and the best Joker, obviously Joker would come out on top, and people will think that Little Mac is like a troll pick or something, right?
But not in this game. You enjoy and you'll win.
Oh yeah, I know, but like, some people will make troll picks, right?
Yeah.
There are things in those kinds of games.
Like that guy who won the Tekken World Championship.
Yeah, he won as Akuma. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Wait,
he won.
Is he a troll pick? Akuma's like really strong, right?
No, he played as Panda.
Oh, but they're the same.
His name is Akuma.
No. That's not his name. I forgot his name, but he played as Panda. But Kuma and Panda are basically the same.
Oh, like, Kuma! Oh,
they're just bears.
I thought
with,
he
like,
said
spikes.
Akuma! I was like...
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, like... Yeah, the only difference between Kuma and Panda is, like, it's just their aesthetics. But they're the same. And a lot of people don't like fighting them, right? Because... It's kind of like a troll pick. Because, like, whatever
I always thought
Kuma
the
does online...
I'd lose to those guys. If I'm fighting a main for those guys, I always lose.
Oh, yeah. But like I said, with Kuma, if you're a really good Tekken player, because most of his moves are slow, and he's it's a big hitbox, so that's why people would probably consider him as a troll pick. Like, he's not like one of the high tier characters.
Even the creator was like, "Yo, I can't believe it."
He won
with Kuma.
Yeah. Everybody was in disbelief that this person won with Kuma.
That sounds like in Pokemon, there was a tournament once. It was like really famous because like somebody's, I think the last Pokemon that like on the team was an Emolga. It won the tournament for it.
Oh my god.
Yeah. And it was up against like, I think it might have even been a legendary.
Yeah, how do you spell that, Emolga?
Emolga. It's it was the Pikachu mascot for the for Gen 4, I think. No, so Gen 4 was Pachirisu, so I think it's Gen 4.
Oh, that! Okay, I remember that.
Yeah, it was the Flying Squirrel Pokemon.
Yeah.
Okay. So anyway, right? There are troll picks, but in this game, like, just looking at the tanks alone, none of the tanks are troll picks.
True.
Yeah. Maybe except Dark Knight and Gunbreaker because of their invuln. Some people that play Gunbreaker could troll their healers by pressing Superbolite and dropping their HP to 1 to wake them up. You know,
bruh.
It could be a troll pick, but if we just look at like clearing raids and other stuff,
the tanks are pretty good.
Yeah, the tanks are really balanced. It's not just even the tanks. Like, you could look at stuff like the healers. White Mage does the most heals, but it doesn't really offer any party buffs that amplify damage.
It can't move either.
Yeah, it can't really move that well either. But it also deals the strongest damage out of all the healers. But again, no party buffs, like no damage buffs. So now let's move over to another game that I find really, really balanced.
Which I also don't
know why people are still, you know, saying this character is bad. Let's go to Genshin real quick.
Let's start with.
You know what? Why put it off? Let's start with Chi Chi.
Alright, let's go.
Let's start with Chi Chi, right? Okay. There are a bunch of reasons. There are a bunch of opinions that I've heard why this character is arguably the worst 5-star in the game.
Bruh.
I even like seen this way before I was even playing Genshin.
Yeah.
It was like a post from one of our friends. It was Sab.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it was because Chi-Chi was like ranked as the worst 5-star or the worst character in the game, or like literal bottom tier, right?
Yeah.
That and then everybody else, they say like Chi-Chi's arguably the worst character in the game. And it's like,
yeah, the Genshin meta pretty weird.
Yeah, it's like okay, why is Chi-Chi bad in most people's eyes, right?
Like, how? Right?
So one guy said that her cryo application.
Zuria?
Huh?
I think you need to move closer to your mic.
Okay.
There we go.
So like one reason, right? Is like somebody said that her cryo application is inconsistent. I was like, okay, I can understand that. But
yeah.
Chi-Chi's a healer, right? So she's got to be good at her heals, right?
Yeah.
And like but she's really, I saw her heals even from like Zuria going in my world to call off Red and to do other stuff. But it's like, her heals are really good. Like, what are people complaining
about? She's actually like, before Kokomi, she's the best healer in the game. And she's really easy to build because all you have to do is keep putting attack. You just attack on everything and just make her attack really high, and then her heals will be really high. It'll heal for 1,000.
Yeah, right. So I'm like, now why are people saying she's bad? She does her job. Like, she does her job really well, albeit her cryo application is inconsistent according to some people, but you know, she does her primary function.
I think the people in like the meta are always just looking at the numbers alone instead of like gameplay application and stuff like
that. Yeah, I know, right? It's like that's what's so annoying.
I'm always on this, like, about Genshin Impact. My I think the most important factors in your gameplay will always be how well you play the game, your strategy playing the game, and your team building. Like, a character on their own cannot be judged for, you know, their skills, right? It's in how you use them in your team and how you build them that matters.
Yeah, exactly. So like, even though I guess like my Dilla could single-handedly carry any team, like that I have, the fact that other characters that I have that people say are bad, when they serve their primary function well, kind of boggles my mind. Like, I guess one example is Raiden. I have Raiden. I got Raiden recently, like a few weeks back.
Big strong.
And strong. I don't know why people are saying that she's like really weak.
I'm pretty, like, I'm, you know, honestly at this point, I'm
it's because of the numbers.
Really. What?
The numbers. All they care about naman is the big damage.
Honestly,
and
I,
that's like.
So, sorry, go ahead.
You're okay.
That's like the big problem, like, ever since the start. Like, okay, so in early Genshin days, you know, you guys know Zhongli is meta now, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yes, okay. I was gonna bring that up, but you go ahead.
When he was first released, everybody was saying he's bad. Like, nobody wanted the role for him. Everyone was like, he's so weak. He doesn't do anything. And then it became such a big issue. MiHoYo actually answered them and said, you guys are playing him wrong.
It's yeah, true, though. They are.
Because he's a shielder. And everyone's logic was like, why do we need to shield? You can just heal everything. And then, you know, from then on, MiHoYo put like a bunch of content that you need to shield in. And it's like, they ended up figuring it out. And like when he got rerun, so many people already like rolled for him and wailed for him. Just because like they realized, oh no, we need shields. And he's like the best shielder in the game.
Yeah, he is. He is the best shielder.
See, my thing is, I think how this started was, is people come from other, like, other gacha games, right? And since other gacha games don't have, like, the similar style of, like, gameplay as Genshin, where it's not really focused on, like, getting... Because in other gacha games, you're like, okay, let's just get the strongest one, get the biggest numbers, because you know a lot of it is automated. So, like, for example, GBF is an automated game, right?
Auto fights,
You know, I'm not denying that there's probably, you know, strategy, but then in GBF, of course, where you
there is
stuff like that. Yeah, of course, right? You know, it's not gonna be
the
devoid.
High end stuff.
It's not gonna be devoid of strategy, of course. But I can see how that mindset comes about. And people are like, okay, I'll play this like how I play my other gacha games. I'll get, you know, the strongest characters, the highest numbers, and then, you know, I'll just win. But it just baffles me that people don't realize how much control they have over what happens on the battlefield. That they don't realize that, you know, that number, you're playing it wrong if you're just focusing on how much numbers appear on the screen, diba?
Yeah.
And like you said, MiHoYo is like pushing people in the right direction. Like, no, you don't, there's no one strategy to winning this thing. You need to have, you know, sometimes your team needs to have a shielder, sometimes you need to focus on healing, sometimes you need to mix all of them together and just have like a well-balanced team. And that's why they're throwing in all these different enemy types, and people are like, no, let's push the meta to this side and then this side, instead of, you know, like using their heads. And
To be honest, that's also the big deal with the Kokomi banner, because she's a healer. And everyone at this point is like, healing is useless. We can just
because you
heal
have Zhongli, yeah.
Yeah, and like, that's the thing. There, according to some leaks, MiHoYo is gonna be adding like enemies that will put damage over time on you that ignores your shield. It's also in the Abyss right now, and like people are whining. They're like, oh, they're forcing us to get Kokomi, and like, you literally don't need to get Kokomi.
You
could
just need a
get
healer, yeah.
They just don't want to like admit it because they don't like seeing like low numbers, because healers, they don't do that much damage.
I really, really...
Hello, Noel, Kokomi.
And that confuses me then, because like, you know, you have healing options from the start, right? You don't get to leave like the first parts of the game without Barbara and Noel, so...
they literally give you for free.
Yeah, just use your heads, come on guys.
Like, Noel is really, really versatile. Like, okay, at C0, this is my Noel. This is how I... Oh my god, that
bro.
Okay. So like in my experience, right? Because like I use my Noel is C0, and basically I only just use it for shield. She's no Zhongli, but her shields are good. And before I even got to use Barbara, her heals were. They exist, but it got me by.
Barbara.
So like, come on, guys. No. Her heals.
Oh, okay. Oh.
She's no.
Noelle's heals.
Yeah, Noelle has a heal.
Yeah, Noelle, of course. Yeah, when you hit people, when you have the shield on.
Yeah, so when I get C1, it like becomes guaranteed the deal. So C0,
it's just a chance.
It gets better when you like grow up higher in the constellations. And with the talents, right?
Yeah,
I believe
she
has a talent that reduces her cooldown. There's a talent that reduces her cooldown for like the shield, I believe, right? Like,
I don't
hit
remember
it by
that.
1 second. There is.
Wait. I have that talent. Mm-hmm.
I've been grinding to get that one. Already.
It basically, it's no Zhongli, but you know what? I'll take it. Right? It's serviceable.
Yeah. Her shields are really good.
Honestly, if you think about it, it's like if you look at all the free characters to give you at the start, you have one for almost each niche like that you need, right? And if you just think for a moment, instead of just like following whatever like posted online, you can actually have like a really good team. Like Barbara has never left any of my team comps. Barbara is on almost every single team comp I have. She's like a permanent member of the team.
I mean, there are people who've cleared Spiral Abyss Floor 12 like over and over with just the starting characters.
Oh yeah, just like Traveler, like Amber, Kaya.
I always have Traveler. Traveler's always in my team. The only times I remove Traveler is when I need extra firepower, so I put Klee in instead. And I like it's Klee, Jungling, Barbara, and Fischl. So I can get that sweet over
nice.
Charge down.
Oh, that's nice, yeah.
That's another thing, to be honest. People, like, I don't know if it's changed that much, but, like, before, people, it's like, they really hate, like, changing characters. They want to do everything with this one. But they kind of fail to realize that you can do way more damage if they're comboing elements with other people in your party.
Yeah, diba? Yeah. That's so strange to me. Again, Like, you have all these options. The game, the game encourages you to like do these things, right? And then people like, no, what is my team song or something like that? Like, you're not playing it correctly.
Yeah,
that's why.
Like, to be honest, that's why I noticed. Like, I stopped a while back, for a while, because my laptop couldn't play Genshin properly. Came back because I can link to the PS4. Then, before. They just used to release characters. Yeah, they just used to release characters. Like, they're like, okay, our next character is this guy. Then they release all the promos and stuff. But this time, like, I noticed since I came back, when they release a new character, they have this infographic showing the skills and what they do. And it actually outright says at the start of the infographic, this character is a insert role.
Like support, secondary DPS.
I've never seen the infographic before, but I do
I've never
they,
seen that. I've never always, seen that either. Though.
They always put out a trailer with dance with like an Yuri Lowenthal narrating something, right? And it says all the skills and what they do.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm so confused how people are like so uneducated and how like the character should be played, or like what's the best role for a specific character, because even if they give you that, right, of course you can build the character however you want, right? So but it baffles me that people are still like, why doesn't it work? Well, because there's a recommended way to play it. You could try that one, or you could build your own, and if you build your own, it's not always guaranteed to work, so why are you complaining about it?
Guaranteed to be good, because it's not always what they like made the character to be. Like, I saw the infographic for Raiden Shogun. It said is a support character. And then everybody is like, yo, her damage is so low, and I'm like,
it's a support, and
she's
what do you mean low damage? I have a 0 Raiden, and I swear she deals more damage than Diluc. Occasionally.
Honestly, I'm not surprised. Like, to hear whenever they release a new character, like to hear like people complain about it, because like they do it with every character. Every new character in Genshin is always the next worst character in the game. That's always how it is.
Man, that's
just
sad.
It's just that some characters get it worse than others, like Zhongli, Albedo, and Kokomi.
True.
It's like really bad because they actually harass you for playing those characters.
Yeah,
that's so strange. That's always so strange.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Speaking of like swaps. Wow, I'm slurring my words. Speaking of swapping characters, let's talk about Yoibi as old. It's like, okay, I want to talk about Yoibi because I personally like this character. I like this character so much. Like, I love playing Yoibi ever since I tried her in her story.
Sorry, I forgot the love... D-Look picture. I didn't put him up on screen.
Oh, no. It's all good.
Also, Noel.
Okay.
There's Yoimiya.
Okay, it's okay. So, Yoimiya. Ever since I tried her during her story quest, I loved every single thing about her gameplay. And here's the thing about me. I hate bow users.
Same.
But Yoimiya... If you were to get my opinion on like who the best bow user is, hands down, Yoimiya. Like at least the most fun.
Say Ganyu.
Yeah, most people would say Ganyu, and I wouldn't mind that. But like,
if I were to weigh in
the fun and the damage, hands down, Yoimiya.
Same. I 100% agree with you. I really like Yoimiya's like it. If she ever reruns, I'm definitely gonna continue rolling for her. I didn't get her last time. I didn't reach 15.
I didn't roll for Yoimiya because, well, yeah. I just didn't get the chance to. But anyway, if she reruns after Zhongli, she's on my radar. That's
You could just enchant your bow, you don't have to charge anything.
Yeah, exactly. That's Ganyu's the thing that I like about her.
Like, Ganyu has the highest damage in the game, but like, the thing is, you have to charge her shot. And like if you don't have C6, that's gonna take so long to charge the shot. And it's so boring.
Oh yeah, that's true. Right. It takes so long, but like, I will agree though, I also like Ganyu. Like, gameplay-wise, because the damage is also big. But it's not as fun as Yoimiya's.
Yeah.
And Yoimiya feels like she does around the same damage anyway, at least when I tried her. So
she feels that way because Yoimiya is super fast.
Yeah, she's
like,
really
every
fast.
Every shot she does is super fast-paced.
Yeah.
And some content creators like Tectone call her Machine Gun Yoimiya.
Yeah, exactly right. The one reason why I just don't like bow users, I have to aim, and when I don't aim, the damage is one, it's bad because they don't flinch, because sometimes the bows miss. With Yoibiya, I get to trigger an element, yeah, and I don't have to aim to put an element on them. And
his normal attack is strong by itself, even if you don't charge it also.
Yeah, exactly. Like, oh my god. Like, she's... And then people call her bad because of her burst.
Bro.
Because they don't want to swap.
Yeah, because...
Wait, what's wrong
burst.
With her burst?
What you're supposed to do is... You're watching this.
Oh my god, that's amazing.
Her burst is... She's gonna jump in the air and put this tree goldfish spinning thing on one of the enemies you hit.
Yeah.
And you have to swap to another character for it to do anything. Like, you have to attack that enemy with another character so that that goldfish thing will blow up over and over again.
Yeah, okay.
Like, okay, if you swap...
What's wrong
though,
with these
like,
people? How is it bad?
Yeah, like, hear me out, right? If you swapped, if I did that with my team comp, I would, like, my D-Look would be dishing out so much more damage. Because my D-Look already hits really hard. And with that ultimate on the enemy, it's like I'm dealing like 5,000 more damage on top of like, what, 6,000 damage every time I hit the enemy.
I never even noticed that you had to switch characters to activate it. Because I'm already switching characters. So what are these people doing? Sticking to one character in the field. You need to keep switching.
Exactly. Like, what's your problem?
I mean, I don't even see the problem. Because like a lot of people to get their screenshot big damage, they honestly... switch characters. They put Bennett's ultimate, they put Supers or someone to put Swirl, and then they put Ona or someone else. They just keep swapping, and then they go to your main DPS last, and then they do a burst, and then wow, screenshot big damage. But then, like, when it comes to actual gameplay, they're like, ah, I don't want.
Like, okay, if like the way you said that, if we follow that logic, then Bennett's also bad.
I don't understand. This stuff should be like muscle memory at this point. If you've been playing this game for so long,
yeah, I've been swapping all the time, and like, I'm not.
Sometimes I'll be playing a different team, and I'll do the same. I'll like not focus on the game at all. I'm just like going through the motions, and I'll do the same like setup I'll do for another team by accident. And I'll when somebody's skill doesn't do the thing I wanted to, I'm like, oh wait, I'm on another team.
Yeah, like that was me with like when I swapped from my main team to like someone with Traveler.
Yeah.
That was like, I was like, cause like Barbara on my main team is where my Traveler is on the other team. So I'm like, okay, I gotta swap to Barbara so that I can get her E off, and then I can swap to Diluc again so that he gets damage boost because I have like the thrill of dragon something something.
Nice.
So
nice.
He gets a damage boost.
Yeah.
And then I swap. And then all I see is like a rock falling from the sky. I'm like, oh yeah, I have Traveler.
for me, it's almost always when I switch Traveler's element. Like I remember when I first got Inazuma and I switched to the Electro one, I got so confused because I'd hold down the button and I'm like, wait, why isn't everybody pulled towards me? Then oh wait, no, I don't have Animo. Okay. then I switch to Animo and be like, I'll let it off real quick. Oh no, I put Gobo in the wrong position. It's not, I don't have Electro on.
Like I also like, I don't know, because like I used to love Animo Traveler before because his swirl is so good.
When I
realized that you could hold it down.
Yeah, yeah.
I was like, oh, damage. It's so good. And it gets another element too, and I'm like, is this the power of Squirrel? And then I got to Liyue and I'm like, and I swapped the Traveler, I'm like, where's my Windblade?
Oh.
I have one more thing about you.
Okay, sure. Go ahead.
First,
if you swap to like a character in another element,
yeah,
it's pretty pog because there's like a lot of elemental reaction. Like for example, I do Yoimiya's burst, so it puts the bomb, then I use Kokomi's burst, so I have to be Kokomi, right? So I'm attacking, and every time I attack, because Kokomi is a catalyst user, it's always hydro, every time I attack and the bomb blows up, it's like automatic vaporized reaction.
It's
really, really high damage.
Nice.
Like vaporize, also the effect of vaporize is like it makes the one that trigger it another but deal more damage.
Mm-hmm.
Or is that melt? I don't know, man.
All of the elemental reactions deal more damage.
Yeah, but like it also gives like a damage boost to like the one that triggered the vaporize effect. Or is it melt? The melt effect. But I know the elemental reactions like deal more damage.
Imagine, right?
That's pretty pog. If you put Yoibia's ult and then Raiden's ult is fully charged.
Ooh, that's nice.
That's what I always do. Because, like, with my setup already, because what I do is when I notice the ring on Raiden fill up, I always swap to Barbara so I can give Raiden the damage boost. And then her ult for B is like, it's already big damage, it's like 18k. So imagine if I had Yoimiya's ult there. It's like, it's just overload until Raiden's ult goes away. It's just so pog. Just imagine. So yeah, kids. The meta and the use of swapping.
In Genshin. In Genshin Impact, yeah.
Yeah.
Bro, yes. Man. I guess
that's my rant. It's been all over the place, but I guess my point is across.
Yeah.
But though I guess the difference is from like Final Fantasy and Genshin, not a lot of people complain in Final Fantasy about their class, except some people with Scholar. But we don't talk about that. I still like Scholar, so you know, some people are unhappy. Anyway. That's basically my meta rant. How it's sometimes stupid, how it's sometimes amazing. How I can finally play a game look at a tier list on how people think of a class or a character. And if my character goes on F tier, I don't really care.
Honestly. You know?
Yeah, me too naman. Like in everyone, even like in Smash, I don't really care where you put the character in the tier list. I just like playing who I like to play.
It's like amazing how you can see so many people on Genshin Twitter go like, oh, what do you mean there's no meta? I just play who I like. Bro, it's like obvious from the start.
Dude.
Alright. But anyway,
like, come on, guys.
Zaria, would you like
don't hate on characters, okay? Don't hate on Kokomi. Stop hating on Kokomi, because you know it's gonna happen. Just do it sooner, okay?
Don't be cringe.
Don't be cringe. Zaria's Kokomi, not fully built Kokomi, healed my Diluc for almost half of my HP. And it's active. Almost all the time. It's better than Barbara. I don't care what anybody says. Okay? You can hate me. I'm right. Her heals are better.
Why are you booing? I'm right.
You know how much HP Barbara heals every attack with her E? 300. What does Zarya's Kokomi do? 4K.
5K actually.
Nice.
It's a K, right? It's not 100. You know? Anyway, don't be cringe, okay?
Meta. Don't be cringe.
Don't be cringe.
Okay. All right. So for today's anime first episode review, we have Akatsuki no Yona, or Yona of the Dawn. You can play the trailer if you want while we're introducing it.
Oh yeah, let's go.
So this is not a new anime. It came out in 2014, I think. Yeah, 2014, 2015, that was its runtime. So basically, the premise of Akatsuki no Yona is there's this red-haired girl that you see on screen. Her name is Yona, and she's the princess of the Koka Kingdom, if I remember right.
It's the Koka.
I don't know why that means.
So it starts out like it's gonna be her 16th birthday, and a lot of episode one is just her fangirling over her cousin. Suwon, the brown-haired guy, and we see a lot of their dynamic as childhood friends. Her, Suwon, and Hak, the general with the blue clothes and the kind of black or dark blue hair. So the basic premise of this is, as we see in episode one, though this might be a bit of a spoiler even though it's in the synopsis, everything goes wrong when, like, her crush Suwon kills her father, the king, on her 16th birthday, and she finds out, and they start trying to chase her, and they have to escape from the palace with her and Hak leaving the palace. So, the thing about Akatsuki no Yona, when it first came out, what really struck a lot of viewers is not like, because this is like a reverse harem. We can see in the opening that there are a lot of guys, right, surrounding her. And what really stood out about this at the time for most of the viewers is that finally it's a reverse harem and the protagonist isn't some naive damsel in distress.
Hell yeah.
Because in the first few episodes, okay, she's still the naive damsel, but like, it doesn't take long because she's literally thrown out there into the world and she really has to adapt to survive because people are out to kill her with all this political stuff going on, and she literally grows into a really strong and independent female lead, and it was like a really new thing for a lot of people because most of the time it's usually it's usually just the girl depending on the guys being strong, but Yona proves throughout the whole season that she can hold her own.
That is true.
So what did you guys think?
I remember, okay, so okay, I'm watching it, right? So
yeah,
Sorry. So it's going through the motions, right? Introducing the characters and stuff.
Yeah.
And then after she talks to Hack, I'm like, then yo, she's preparing for some guy. It's gonna be some pretty guy, I guess, right? And then I'm like, oh, it's gonna be this dude again, like this type of dude, this type of character. Then as soon as he shows up on screen, I was like, yep, that's him, and he's gonna be the villain. As he showed up, he was like, you know, he had the face and he had the look to him, and I was like, yep, that's the bad guy. And then
he had the face.
The episode was trying so hard to convince me that he wasn't, but every time I saw a scene where he was not being a bad guy, I was like, hey, this guy's kind of nice. But then I'm also like, but, he kind of looks.
When he saw it, he's like, I knew he was.
Yeah, I was like, when we got to that point of that, I was like, yeah, I knew he's a bad guy.
I knew it was you.
Cause like the show, and it's honestly pretty well written and like well animated too. Cause like if you pay attention, you can see the parts where he thinks nobody's looking, like when he does when he lies to Hack, right, and then Hack leaves. As soon as he leaves, you keep looking at someone. Oh wait, how do you say his name?
Suwon.
Oh,
that's a different
Suwon.
I didn't notice like Hack looking.
Suwon, when Hack leaves, right? Suwon, he just makes like, you know, the kind of evil face.
Oh yeah, yeah, there is an imposter among us.
Omogus.
He makes like that suspicious look.
I was like,
bruh.
not gonna lie, that was the first sign that put me off, and I was like, nah, he could be like that. He was probably looking like that because he's keeping an eye out for that suspicious guy that, you know.
Wait, that was your that first sign? Not when he like grabbed her in the dark?
Yeah, he grabbed her in the dark.
Okay.
That was the point. I was like, yeah, for sure, this is the bad guy.
I didn't think that. I was just relieved. I don't know. I'm probably just dumb.
I was like, maybe he saw the guy and was like trying to keep her quiet, right? But then like when he gets there, he played dumb and I was like, that doesn't make sense. You're pretending you didn't see him, because why else would you grab her that way, right?
Yeah, if he saw the bad guy, he would. Yeah, that rationalizes grabbing her and like covering her mouth so she doesn't make a sound, because he's like, oh, there's someone outside. Kind of sus, and she ran in here panic. But then when he pulled away and she was like, someone was following me, and he was like, what, really? And I was like, what?
Yeah, and then immediately he's like, I don't know, he starts giving like this, his character changes immediately, and he's like, oh no, don't go near me, blah blah blah. And then like he started to say all of this like stereotypical like romantic nonsense, and then like I was like, yeah, I know, I got your number, bro, I know what you do.
I got your number,
I got their seats right here.
I caught you in 4K.
How about you though, Jane? What was your experience like going through the episode?
What a roller coaster. Man. All of that in one episode,
man.
Yeah.
Don't you like that? How do you like that?
And they pretty much ran the romance between Suwon and Yona. But then at the end, they ruined it.
Yeah, oh, I forgot. I forgot to mention. Honestly, when we got to the guy, I was like, oh, that's probably the bad guy. And then this thing took me out a bit for a bit. Like, he was telling the backstory, and then she said, "Cause," and I was like, what? And then it got to the king, right? And the king was like, you can't have Suwon. And I was like, well, yeah, of course, it's her cousin. And then I forgot. Royal people do that.
And it's like, it's not just royal people. It's also kind of historical setting. So it's still justifiable.
Yeah.
It's really a problem.
That was my first two, TJ. Don't worry. I was like,
you were like, what?
I was like, cause like the thing threw me on a loop. I don't know. It probably didn't throw you guys on a loop, but it did throw me for a loop.
It did. Like just saying all this stuff, and then cousin, huh?
I love Suwon. It is like it shows a flashback to when they were kids, and then it's like it gives off the vibe na parang he sees Yona as like a child or his little sister, and then Yona sees him as a lover, and then I heard cousin, I'm like, what?
No, just say it. And
me, then adjust glasses. Naruhodo.
I was so like you know when you get to the part where he's like killing the king, right? You know, yeah. At that part you should be sad, right? Like, oh no, this like terrible thing has happened. Oh, sorry. I'm so sad to say that I was relieved because I was like, yeah, he's not gonna be in the harem. Yeah, let's go. That was so bad.
Yeah, to be honest, when the first time watching this, I watched this around release, so it was like 2014.
When I
saw him killing the king, I was like, oh damn. And I was like, this is even better.
What?
Oh my god.
I was like, this makes Suwon even better. I literally read like the manga and lived for Suwon screen time after that.
Oh my god. Let's go. I gotta say though, I really like the art, even though it's pretty old. I like it.
Oh yeah.
Me too. Not gonna lie, I thought it was gonna be an even older anime because of the reference image Zuria sent me. Then I remembered, no, this looks like it came from the How to Draw Manga like website. I was like,
Yeah, it was.
Yeah. I was like, yeah, that makes sense, yeah. I'm trying to like remember something I wanted to say about the anime. Oh man. It was about the characters, what? Yeah. Okay, so ever since I've been getting more into like the I don't want to say obscure anime, but basically non-mainstream stuff, right? So
yeah,
quite a lot of them have a lot of like, oh ho ho, here's the trick, got you moments, and then like because of that, I have like so much trust issues with any anime I watch, even if it's like a normal anime. As soon as somebody makes like a sus move, I'm like, hold on, wait a minute. And then like I start reevaluating every scene I've seen this character in, and I'm like, are they gonna do some messed up stuff? Cause like who's that other guy? The guy who's like serving stuff to the king, right? The other dude, the headband.
Oh yeah, into
him, right? He approaches Hack and hands him something, and I'm like, no wait, it might be poison. Stop.
You know, right? I also thought that I was like,
because he says something kind of sus when he gets there. I forgot what it was, but it sounded super sus. Like when the way he said it, the way he approached Hack, and then I was like, oh wait, no.
Something. It was something about.
He's not in it.
So
he's not in
like,
on it. Yet.
Yeah. So
yeah,
I
yeah.
was like. So I was like.
Yeah.
Oh,
he came.
Hack,
he came.
You're gonna die.
He just slid up to him at the party and was like, shouldn't you be with the princess? And I was like, wait, what did you do?
Oh yeah.
What did you do?
Yeah, I know, right? He was like, shouldn't you be with the princess? I'm like. Oh, to ensure she's asleep, huh? Mm. Uh-huh.
But then it just turns out Minsu was just like asking him because it's really his job, you know?
Yeah, it's really his job, yeah. It's like,
he's a real one.
He a real homie.
He's a real homie.
Bro.
But yeah.
Oh man. But also, I also really like how they're setting up the character arcs. Because like the whole time, the whole episode, do you know what's gonna happen to Yona, right? Because they showed her
it's in the freaking synopsis.
Mm-hmm. No. What I mean is like they show her first, right? And, she's different, and then you go back in time, and then she's completely different. And they keep hammering home on like you know all these like tropes and stuff of like the main character, and they're like, yeah, okay, this is gonna be good because we know that she's gonna change from this to like you know, this thing.
Yeah.
Makes you want to see the actual growth.
Although, you know, honestly, every time I'm like, okay, this is the bad guy, I really want to be wrong. Because if they are, it's always horrible. Like whenever I say, I'm like, yep, that's the bad guy. It's always horrible. Like, it's always gonna be some messed up thing if this person actually was the bad guy. And I always want to be wrong, but I rarely ever am wrong about like, okay, this is the bad guy. And I'm like, ah.
PJ plays Ace Attorney when.
True.
So PJ can be like, I wanna be wrong. I wanna be wrong.
I really want to play Ace Attorney though. I'm a big fan of like Phoenix Wright because I see him in. I played him in other games, and I also watch like Ace Attorney stuff.
I'm just kidding. You have a DS, so you probably can.
I think it's on DS. It is on the DS, yeah. Ace Attorney's on the DS.
Get it digitally downloaded. Oh, okay, never mind.
Yeah, just like other.
Yeah, everything on. That everything that I don't have.
We could play it here on the podcast, I guess, like as a group, maybe.
We watch like TJ play.
Yeah, like one of us like streams it, and then we all decide what happens.
Yeah, that could work.
Hell yeah!
So
yeah.
If you guys don't own the game, I own the game. It's fine.
Nice. Okay, so you can stream it. But okay. I want to talk about the OP and the ED. Like, growing up, I've never been really a big fan of OPs that are just the instrumental. Like, there are some that I really like. Like, for example, like the Daredevil, like OP for the Netflix show. I really love that opening theme. But, like, I guess it kind of started when Ben 10 switched to, like, Alien Force and they didn't have any lyrics to the theme song. I was like,
I still like that, though.
Me too. I do like the Alien Force theme, but I'm like, you know, I really like it when there's, like, a song has lyrics. So, but the OP, though, this OP, I like its vibes. But the ED, though, of this anime, I like much more. I really like the sound of the ED. I think it's like, really cool. I say that, and I'm trying to remember what it even sounded like. But all I remember is like, yeah, I really, this ED slaps. Like
I'm pretty sure it was a calm kind.
I can barely remember it, but I remember when the anime ended. I was like, this slaps.
Well, I'll tell you, the second opening song has lyrics.
Oh yeah, let's go!
But the first one, I still really like the first one because even though it's just like music, it's just OST. It's like setting the vibes already.
It does, yeah, it does.
And it's like, actually, I don't know if you guys will notice, but if you guys continue watching, it's going to be used in the background as the OST in like a lot of different renditions to set the mood in action scenes, in sad scenes.
Nice.
So usable.
Yeah, honestly, I can see that. It's a great motif to have for like for OST.
Yeah.
Pretty good.
But the song, the second opening also slaps. You guys will see it eventually.
Hell yeah.
You continue to, yeah. I know I'm gonna continue it.
I'm putting it on my list. Yeah.
Nice.
I just want.
So
to see...
how?
Oh, sorry.
Go ahead.
I really want to see it now. I just want to get to the romance part. So I want.
Yeah, dude.
I want to see like who her choices are and like okay, which one am I betting on?
I see.
Yeah.
I think the safest bet is Hack, but I can't remember properly.
He's a strong contender.
Hack is a very strong contender. I like
Hack.
Yeah, I like him. He's really cool.
Giga Chad Hack.
Yeah.
Jesus, the princess. You know that's the actual OTP right there.
As soon as he came
What do you mean, Suwon? You guys are just sweet.
But as soon as this happened, I was like, yeah, This guy.
He's a strong contender.
Yeah, true.
You'll see the others very slowly over time.
Yeah, dude.
Hell yeah.
Anyway, so I guess you guys liked it overall, huh?
I wouldn't like the theme,
because
like I'm not like the theme of the song, like not the song, but the anime, like
like the past.
It's kind of like it's a dynasty stuff. Kind of thing, you know.
I'm not that big into dynasty stuff, right?
Yeah, I'm not big into dynasties, but you know what? This is fine.
I like it.
I like it.
If anything, I'll stay on. I just want to see more of.
Same. Hack.
Yeah.
That's okay. Hack's always there.
Let's go.
Yeah, Chad
it's
Hack.
Like if you make an RPG out of this, he's like your first party member, and he's never gone.
So. Hell yeah. Oh, just like in Genshin, you always have Aether.
Yeah. You always have Traveler.
Let's go, baby. That's what I've been waiting for. That's what it's all about.
That's what it's all about.
Yeah, I was actually like really curious about you guys' reaction because this is actually like obviously catered to women.
Oh yeah. But I'm big into romance. I don't care like what it's catered to.
Nah.
As long as the romance is sweet and it gets the heartstrings. Like,
oh yeah, there's a lot like that.
Let's go!
Let's go!
You just gotta keep going.
Hell yeah!
That's what I'm waiting for!
That's what it's all about!
Unfortunately, no season 2. You just have to continue into the match.
I hope it gets
there's one. No season 2?
Yeah.
Like,
there's an OVA from the manga, but...
Oh yeah, that was on the list when I looked it up. There's an OVA.
Okay, that's pretty good. I like
it.
Yeah. Same. I like it. I recommend it. Anyone who wants like an
Akatsuki no Yona, I give this rating not cringe. Based.
Nah.
Akatsuki no Yona, based Daijoku.
based out of 10. So yeah, I really like this. I really like this.
Nice.
Masterpiece.
Is there anything else anyone wants to say about the anime?
I'm good. I don't want to spoil. All
right.
I'm also good.
We gotta keep some stuff for the audience, right?
Yeah.
We gotta keep some stuff for the audience.
In that case, we have another fantasy setting to visit, don't we?
we do?
Yeah, Jien. Lead the way. What?
Wait, what? Hang on, I'm lost. what section is it already?
You're
gonna play.
You're already dressed up for it, right?
Come on. Okay.
We're gonna play Genshin Impact. Yeah, baby.
I totally dropped the ball on that one.
An attempt at a smooth transition.
Yeah.
Nah, it was good.
I was so lost because I was like, what comes after the first ad? What was that in the first episode review again?
You know.
Oh yeah, it's the sharing segment or the game segment or something.
You know, before we transition though, hold on, I just want to point out, I'm kind of salty sometimes whenever we do art preferred off panel because the big number like on the side always covers like the detail of Jean's like stuff.
Yeah.
Like I always remove it so I can actually draw, so I can see where I'm drawing, right? And then when I put it back on, like stuff's covered. Like you can't see like the crystal that's on like D-Luke's like necktie and then the other stuff.
Salty.
Yeah.
Oh well.
We're gonna head on over to Genshin Impact and then we'll be right back here for our next segment.
Yo, what's up, gamers? We're gonna play some Genshin for our little sharing turned gaming segment. We're gonna play Genshin.
What's up, Genshiners? We're about to impact this Genshin.
That's so crack. Anyway, since Zarya's and my world level are too high, we're gonna join the TJs.
Nice.
Let's go, TJ.
I was flying. Wait. Okay, accept world join. Very cool. I don't really have anything planned in my world right now. But I do have my daily comms. I guess we could go do that. Maybe
we can help with that.
I will help you as my level 35 Bennett.
Sakta, you're using D-Loop. You're also wearing D-Loop's coat. Let's go.
But you know.
No. I mean, you're using right now. You're D-Loop, right?
Oh yeah, I'm D-Loop. As you can see, this is my favorite character. And I know.
I don't have it
so
right.
Biased.
Oh man. Maybe I should have switched to Animo Tablet so I could shout win play.
Okay.
Lightning flash. Yeah.
You still have this thing. Why aren't you getting it?
Oh, this? Oh my! I didn't walk here. Okay, I didn't see it.
Oh my god! Did you just get here?
I've been here, but apart from like opening some teleport waypoints on this island, I've just been mostly doing anything other than the story quest.
What?
I was grinding kasi during the last one. I didn't get any Zhangling constellations. I got three sucroses and then one Beidou. It wasn't even on the banner.
Ayos.
Well, at least I have Beidou now. I didn't have to like get this.
Oh, one. Nice.
Yo, what's up? It's me.
Sucrose 2.
Level 35 Bennett.
All right, let me see what's the closest daily com. Oh, it's actually here. Complete the challenge by dispersing the electro fog. I think this is a fighting one. Oh wait, no, that's not the closest one. That's the furthest. I'm blind. Okay, this one's the closest one. All right, it's at the edge of. Oh, Zaria's already warped there.
I also warped here too.
Okay.
If I end up liking Bennett, I might actually swap Barbara out.
I heard Bennett's good for that, Bennett.
Yeah, I'll just build energy recharge so his heal is up more.
Yeah.
Besides that, what's up, it's me, Bennett.
Alright, plug and play that. Commission accepted. All right.
Probably gonna die, but you know what? That's fine. That's fine.
How are we gonna die? Is there a ask me?
No, but like, I could get hit once and I'm dead.
Alright.
Remember, I'm level 35.
Oh, okay.
I don't need any damage. Yeah, that's my damage. Definitely my damage instead of the damage.
Bruh.
Wait, was that it? Oh, hold on. I was wondering, hold on, like, shouldn't there be more enemies?
Yeah.
There we are. Woo! Close that.
Crazy.
Whoa! Half of damage boost.
Crazy! Nice, the heals.
My heals don't do anything. What the?
Lightning flash! Getting over it with Bennett Mush.
I'll swap back.
Alright, thanks guys. Let's go. Let's see what's the next
one. I want to try how frequent. That's not what I meant to use.
No. I think I'll switch then, because the next one's the slime balloon, and I hate that.
Oh, the slime balloon? Alright. I'll try this, because you guys are gonna rack up energy for me.
The slime balloon?
Slime?
Where is it?
Is it there on Yashi?
Oh, it's sabotage the slime balloon.
Yeah, I hate this thing so much. The good thing is that I was hoping we would get this one during that Discord. Because I hate doing this on my own. After like getting to this world level, it takes so long to destroy it.
Okay, wait. I got this.
I want to try it with Raiden. Yo, double clee! Wait, we have...
Double clee! Let's go!
Be quick! Illusion shattered. Hey guys, rack up energy for me. La la la.
Oh my gosh. Let's both land on top of that.
Bruh, on top? It's too late.
Oh, okay. I'm here. Wow!
Yeah, my auto attacks deal no. Okay, we are. Okay, Zaria is doing all the damage.
Zaria did all the damage.
Yep. That was.
Wait,
it's
dead?
It was all 5k. It was all 5k.
Dang, it's dead already.
There was like a few under 1k ones, and that was me.
My thing didn't even recharge. Look at that. My eye didn't even recharge.
Because I didn't use any burst.
Yeah.
Oh, it's only when you use a burst?
Yeah, it's only when you use a burst.
Other characters using burst charges.
Burst is an ult, right? That's what a burst is.
Yeah.
If Raiden uses hers, then the glowy is gone.
Okay, let's see what's the next
one. Level, TJ?
Hold on, let me check.
50.
Yeah, 50.
50 queen!
I don't really focus on leveling Kui because she's one of the strongest ones on my team. I focus more on the ones I need to you know, have like support role, really fit into support roles. My highest one right now, I think, is Traveler and Jungling. Yeah, Traveler is at 65 and then Jungling is 61.
Bang.
Someone heal me.
Definitely gonna level up these.
Lost 2,000 HP.
DJ, heal her. We don't have a healer. I want to try my stacks.
Barbara needs someone to heal another person.
Oh no.
We need to do another commission, ASAP.
Go,
Barbara,
go! Let's warp another person.
Okay.
Where's the next one?
Closest one is in what's this place? Serai.
Oh yeah, yeah, here. Near Kosuke village.
Yeah.
I.
Yeah. Oh, let's fight. Long ago, we were talking
let's fight
about
the
meta.
Oh my, yeah. Let's fight the thunder thing, the bat one.
Man, my thing would be useless. Just let me use my burst.
Hey. Do you see that tree? Wait, I'm not there yet.
Oh wait, hold up. You understand?
So teleported to the other side. Is it on top?
Yeah.
I have no idea. Complete the challenge by dispersing the electro fog. What do we do here?
I think we need
an animal.
Yeah, we need an animal.
Oh,
it can be level 20.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be high level.
But here's then the we're gonna see. Enter the fight, and I'm gonna be level 20.
Oh. Wait, let me, because I can have two characters on the field.
Okay.
Alright. Are you gonna switch to a healer or no? Because I can keep Barbara on the team.
You can remove if you want.
That's also a healer. No, I'm just kidding. We have two healers.
Let's just go. Where's the thing? what am I looking for? I don't think I've ever gotten this quest before.
That's not the thing we're supposed to. That's not the thing.
Yeah, I know. I'm looking for a fog.
Is it? Do we need it on the
middle vision?
She went.
Wait, I almost fell off the mountain. Where'd you go? Oh, there's a cat. Why are we gonna leave? Die.
Oh, he's
on
me. Let me.
Oh,
there we go.
Oh, nice one! And
you. Yay, item drops.
That's nice.
Separate item drops, by the way.
I always wondered which ones are client side and which ones are.
The resources like crystals, Naku weed. If it's dropped from a monster, it's client side.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you guys see these mushrooms? Can I grab these? Yeah, it doesn't matter.
The GN mushroom.
Where is? Illusion shattered.
What is this thing?
All right. So we're looking for a fog, right? So there should just be a buzzer.
Oh.
What?
I think it's on top of this cliff.
Oh. Okay.
Oh. I see.
No, I was wrong.
No, it's not there.
I'm checking this other.
I was wrong. Now just looking around. Oh no! Entered the face gate.
What happened?
I entered the face gate. What? Where is the fog? Usually it's right there.
Amokumu fruits for it. I just picked up a bunch of them.
It's for A.
Ooh, this is out of their range, it's not here.
I'm looking.
It's weird.
Yeah, I'm lower down and I'm not seeing it.
I'm on top. Weird. Usually there's a kind of obvious fog, but I don't see anything.
Me neither. Illusion shattered. Like if I travel to one
it
of these things.
It can't be a solo only thing, right?
Are you using elemental side?
Maybe it is.
You could try using elemental side to try find it. But we Arlo was able to blow fog away when we were there.
Oh, okay. Elemental side, right. So, let's see. There is no escape. I don't see it near the top of the cliff.
Same.
What does it actually look like, though?
It looks like blobs.
Oh.
It looks like a blob of.
Oh, I'm away from the thing. I'm outside of it.
I'll teleport back up there.
Bruh.
I'm under attack.
Oh, you're fighting something.
Oh my god.
I'm under attack.
Wait, I'm on the way.
You're not dying,
I'm under attack.
You're not dying, are you? Oh my god.
Taff, I'm trying attack. To get there so I can actually like heal. Shine
down. Okay, it's dead.
See? They're dead, no! Now you can't.
Crazy.
Crazy.
Hmm.
Where is it?
Usually it's right there.
It's not here, so what? Come on.
It's okay, I'm...
It needs
oh wait, do you already switch? I was gonna
Oh no.
What?
It's okay. No,
not down here either.
Are we just blind?
Maybe. Wait, I have an idea where else it can be if it's this area.
Alright.
I'm just finding the entrance. If I'm not remembering, please.
Mushroom. What if I launch myself into the sky? Maybe I can see. No. I'm already flying above the island and I can't see it. It just looks like a blob, right? So yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it should be obvious. It's a blob, right?
Yeah, it's purple.
Yeah, and it shouldn't be here, so why is it so hard to find? I see you guys.
I can't find it.
Maybe. Oh, wait. Is it inside this thing?
Inside what thing? Where are you? Did you
underneath,
find the thing that I was looking
underneath
for?
The cliff is a cave.
Yeah, I was looking for that cave. I just couldn't find it. You could check there.
Oh,
yeah,
there it is.
Just
oh, there.
Bro.
Nice, finally. We're blind.
It was inside the thing.
One sec, I'm on my way.
How do we clear it? I'm just rolling around right now.
At the speed of sound.
Yeah, I cleared one.
Got places.
How you do be Sonic? Wait, how does this work?
You clear it with anime.
Oh. Oh, wait. Oh,
never mind.
Oh.
Oh, I'm level 20.
No! Sorry! I didn't even get to throw Muji Muji Dharma into the thing.
Give me Dharma.
I don't have any revival items. Oh, no.
Damage isn't anything stellar, but. Where the hell is it? Where did it go? I can't attack it in this thing. What is it going up?
It's going up! Animo. Yeah, Animo, Hydro, and Electro are hitting it. Wait, that was it? It was just that one? Bro.
Yeah.
So mad.
Bro,
right, the next daily comp is just it's just the kid again, so I'll do that later. You guys want to find something?
What do you guys want
to find? What do you need to fight?
Hold on, let me check.
I'm pretty sure Fischl is near another ascension. I think we could fight the thunder thing.
The manifestation. Wait, what?
Wait, yeah, the bat looking one.
She needs the bat.
No.
I think she needs hypostasis more. I think Fischl needs the hypostasis more, because this is more towards Sara and Raiden.
I mean, it would still be cool to fight it. Just
but my old, oh my god. Well, either way, I guess I'm.
Oh wait, no, I do need to fight O'Shannon.
O'Shannon. Oh well, whatever. Fine, I'll find it.
O'Shannon. Yeah.
Okay.
O'Shannon for Barbara.
For Barbara O'Shannon. Yeah, let's go.
All right, I'll TP over. Let's go. I hate this boss because I don't have a competent Go user level though. I have.
Yeah, you could use a catalyst.
Where's the? I'm just gonna warp to a nearby statue of 7 versus so you can recover.
Would you? I love. I don't really like. Well, I haven't leveled up Sayu, but I'll admit her E is so fun.
Muji Dharma.
What the hell? Okay, never mind.
Muji Dharma.
It's just a section of Zeria saying Muji Dharma.
Win.
It took so long to load that by the time I loaded in, Sayu was already done healing at the statue. I'm dead. Alright, I'm switching Sayu for someone else.
I'll let you guys know I'm probably not gonna be good damage here.
If it... What do you mean you're Electro?
No, I mean like to the birds.
Oi! The hell? You're attacking.
What?
Muji Dharma.
The you who are the
the you who are.
You are.
A foo-foo windmill, a foo-foo.
Dane reading all of that.
Muji Dharma.
If only Electro doesn't hurt actual players.
Does it?
It does.
Yo, I didn't even notice Noelle's health is at 10,153 now.
Nice.
Huggers.
Yeah, Electro, when you're in water, you end up killing yourself.
When Razor hits the ground, the Electro like charges the one.
Yeah, because it comes Electro charge.
He's really strong though, Razor.
Yeah, he is. I didn't know you could hold this.
Yeah, this you can.
Yeah, I only found out recently.
Muji Dharma.
I probably should have been the fish on the one.
Who trespasses upon the waters of
I forgot Noelle's shields won't appear on you guys.
Oh wow, the homing, the pirates are homing. In this way,
shall we? Yeah.
Inazuma shines eternal! There we go, look at that damage.
Yeah, electro charge.
That was probably not all we need.
No, I haven't.
Sorry, you killed the other one before I could even hit it.
I haven't even built you immediately yet.
Man, but you deal like 2k damage, that's more than my demon.
It's more than both me and Jin's damage combined.
Actually true.
Illusion.
I'm dying! Oh god!
Oh wait, there
you
go.
Yeah, it's your electro charge killing you.
Okay.
Muji Dharma.
Just hit the enemies later when they come up to you, dude.
I think my E's gonna run out before I just wish the boss didn't have so much like animation. Happy animation. Alright, time to heal. No, it's just stupid cranes! I hate cranes!
What's wrong with the cranes?
Nothing, they're just annoying. Especially when they're pirates, like the birds that like swoop down on you. That's why I have Noelle equipped, so if they accidentally hit me, I'm dead.
I'm probably triggering a lot of people because I see my health. Fails also
to comprehend its
world. Muji Dharma.
Let's
go!
No! No! Shield!
What happened?
That appears to not and he just one hit with no pulse.
The
switch
is ready, by the way. This thing is gonna explode.
Yeah.
Muji Dharma.
You say that, but you're the one closest to it, means you're attacking from afar.
What else do I have? What choice do I have? There, that's what I bet. It still hit.
Oh, oh.
I was late.
Yeah, I didn't even notice it was still exploding. I thought it already went. The Fufu windmill.
The power of water
is its ability to change.
Shake it. Please shake.
How
I can't actually hear. I can't actually hear. You know these guys are actually from thing. The ocean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh, geez, gonna die. There we go, healed.
Uji Uji Daru.
Uji Uji Daru.
Risk but a small haven of tranquil waters. Is that so much to ask? As long as rain falls,
thanks, guys.
And rivers flow,
water will exist forever.
See what else I need for this.
I think I should. I'll just swap to Diluc. I don't want to die anymore.
I'm still dying.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, let's go for Komi. She's good, by the way, guys. She's good. I don't care what anybody said.
The book of Komi.
I don't care what anybody says.
Oh, hey, nice video.
This character is better than Barbara. I'm saying that right now. I don't care what anybody says.
Let's go to Guyun Stone Forest. I want to fight the
Ruin Guards.
No, the G.
Oh my god! I thought you were gonna say you wanted to fight the Ruin Guard.
You were saying G and Hypostasis. I'm like, what are you?
I did say the G and Hypostasis.
Nechika.
Mondstadt is the city of dreams. No, dreams. No, I messed it up already.
The city of. Oh my god.
Manila, I was gonna say it last though.
Manila Mondstadt is the city of freedom. Wait.
Okay. No, wait, where did you guys go?
Oh, wait, you said to go to the Guyan Stone Forest.
Yeah. First, let's curb stomp this guy. The pyro this mage, I hate this so
I don't think I'll be of any help. Break the shield first.
I'm breaking the shield. I hate the fire.
Sweat, where are you?
It's whenever I respawn from the teleport. I hate you so much.
Why did you guys go to the domain?
Domain? We didn't go to the domain.
No, it's a free teleport.
What do you mean? I didn't go to the domain. That's a domain?
That's a domain.
Yeah. Yeah.
The teleporter is closer though.
Is it? Wait, sorry. I forgot that these islands are connected. I thought we would have to swim if we went there.
Yeah, you would have to swim.
Oh, okay.
Komi's here is 20% less swimming stamina.
Wait, why is this thing still alive? I thought we killed it.
I didn't actually see where it
was. Yeah, teleported to the room. My god, okay. Shit. Where is it? Oh, it's there.
I got it.
Alright.
I single ulted it. And I tilted. Dealt 12k, holy shit. Oh, I mean,
it's.
Oh, we're cutting that out.
I mean, there were some stuff in the anime review.
And he almost swore in the anime review, but he didn't go through anything.
I did.
Yeah, both of us.
Yeah. I don't remember.
Yeah, both of us.
Make this close.
Yeah, right, both of us.
Now let's head over there, okay. Every time I see an Abyss Mage out in the wild, I just wanna.
You just wanna kill it.
Yes.
Does this apply for Kaya?
Oh,
whoa!
Oh no.
Omoshiroi.
Naruhodo.
Naruhodo.
Where are you guys? Oh, there you guys are. I can see you guys running past the healing trails.
You mean past Kaya? I mean, what?
I remember when we were playing with Arlo, the whole time on the way to the Geo Hypostasis, every single mob followed him.
Yeah.
And only him, they went right past us just to follow Arlo.
You guys good?
Yeah, I'm switching. Hold on. Oh wait, no, never mind. I don't need to switch.
Wait, I'll switch. And I'll switch.
To what? Osh! Oh, let's go.
Oh wait, I should actually use Chongyun.
Sheesh! Let's go, Chongyun.
Chongyun.
Sheesh.
You're gonna be my cryo enabler. Thank you.
Sheesh.
Oh my god, I dealt 9k.
You have all this stuff just like flying onto the hypostasis.
I'm actually dealing 9k? What? No.
It's melt, yeah.
I used
melt
this
two times.
Melt this two times, so that's amazing.
Oh, there it is. What?
This.
How did it do that?
It does that.
It does that more often than you.
Yeah. I know, I took so long killing this when I ascended. Because I don't have a claymore.
Oh yeah. Nice.
Easy.
Are you guys gonna know? Who are you gonna roll for in the next banners? Or if you are going to roll, or
the next banner?
Like for Thoma or something. Are you gonna roll for Thoma or something?
I'm saving for Yunji.
I want Yunjin. If there's no Yunjin. Huh?
Wait, who's that one again?
It's not yet released. It's a black haired girl from the
Wii. Oh yeah, the one you guys were sharing in the Discord.
Yeah.
That's right. Oh, you guys have access to it, right?
I take my meal's call to quiet the spirit.
Her name just like escaped me for a second there. You guys have access to Aloy already, right?
To what?
Aloy.
I have, yeah.
Aloy? I don't have Aloy.
Wait, hold on. What version did she come for everyone? Because for me and Zaria, we just got her earlier, but what about you guys?
Version
2.2. Well, no, it's not yet 2.2. I thought it came with the banner update.
Does that bow come with Aloy?
For if PS4. You're on PS4.
That's so... Okay then.
I don't know why. If
it's probably like a deal with me or something.
Come on, man.
Well, if he... I think someone suggested in one of the Genshin GCs that you could just... You could just make a PlayStation account and link it. I think it works the same.
I'm not sure. There are people who said that, but then they would say that it needs to be played on PS4.
Oh, so you really have to open it within a PS4.
I'm not sure.
Hmm?
What else we doing?
Oh, I know. I was just trying to find a topic because it's for us to talk about while we're fighting the mobs. And I thought I'd bring up some like of the new stuff in Genshin. But let's see. Wait. Hold on, we have to wait for these things to respawn. That's right.
I mean, I could bring up this one thing that I saw recently.
Sure, go ahead.
It's just really short.
No, yeah, go ahead.
One of the YouTubers, said, "Imagine having a C6 R5 D-loop," and I was like, "Ouch,
bruh."
And then like it cuts to the clip of another YouTuber with like 3-crown D-loop.
Nice.
They look good. Though. I don't care what anybody says.
Let's fight the cryo hypostasis.
All right.
The cryo one, yeah.
I haven't tried fighting it actually.
It's not enough. Dragon's fight.
I've only fought it. Is our recording supposed to be again? 45 minutes, right?
I think so, yeah. How close are we now?
We're at 31 minutes.
Nice. Okay, and yeah, what other topics about the engine you want to talk about while we're fighting?
The Enkanomiya, I guess. Have you guys done that world quest, Moonbathe Deep?
World what?
World quest series, Moonbathe Deep.
No, not yet.
Wait, sorry, you cut off, on my end, I didn't hear what
you said. Moonbathe Deep, Sunwatatsu.
Oh, I haven't done a world quest in Watatsu.
Okay, never mind. Never mind, never mind.
Alright. You guys here?
Yeah, we're here. We need you to turn this on before I start
freezing
today.
Yeah,
what do you mean? Turn on the thing!
Oh! I forgot!
What are you doing? Turn it on! You have to turn everything on.
Forgot. Sorry, I always assume you get on it. Wait, why are you over there? Go back!
I'm dead.
No! No!
I have died.
Sorry, I switched out to Barbara because I thought you were gonna say it's so I switched out to the healer.
Nah, it's okay. I'm back.
Hey, I did it! Oh wait, no!
Oh, you know! I hate the cryo hypothesis like homing attack thing. So my.
Oh god!
Why does this one hit so hard? It's not even.
The thunder manifestation is hard.
It's okay. I think
this one is the thunder manifestation.
Thunder manifestation? I think they're both fine.
I find this one harder than the thunder manifestation. Just because it didn't. Just because of its attack patterns. But the thunder manifestation, it just takes too long.
I was supposed to smack it into. That was my bad. I don't fight this thing a lot.
I may be dying.
No!
I'm alive.
Alright, let's get out of
here. What kind of rewards do you get here anyway?
It's a specific one for, you know, it's called Crystalline Bloom. You only get it for killing this thing.
So, I assume Rosaria.
No, for Alloy.
Oh, Alloy. Yeah. Just Alloy?
But I don't have Rosaria, so she probably has it.
Pretty sure it could also be for you.
I don't know if I don't know, maybe I should roll on this banner, I'm not sure. Cause I'm close to I'm close to pity. I'm, I think, like 30 away from it or something. So I don't know if I should use it now or save it for another 5 star, I don't know.
It depends if you want.
I really wanna get Toma, but I'll just fish for him if ever when Zhongli reruns.
Well, we don't really know. There's no confirmation what it's going to.
The thing is, kasi ano eh, don't mind. I'm struggling to remember how to pronounce the other guy's name. Goro, right? Goro.
Yeah.
Goro. Goro and Toma are they're both four stars. Yeah, right. So I don't really have to worry about missing them. You know,
yeah,
as long as I grind enough to be able to, you know, roll for them. But yeah. I don't know, cause if I use my pity now, I don't know, it's not anymore yung guaranteed banner for 5 star, cause I failed the 50-50 earlier with when I got you.
So it's gonna be guaranteed now.
Yeah, on the next time. But I don't really have anyone else I'm really waiting for as a 5 star, unless mag-rerun si Yoimiya, which won't be for, you know, a long time.
Yeah, she just had her run that way.
Mm-hmm. I might as well use it on a good character.
Yeah.
I'm still after Zhongli though, so I'll just fish for Toma in Zhongli's banner if ever.
Alright,
if I get Zhongli, I'll just maybe it depends on who the characters are out at the time.
Yeah.
Can we go to Oceanic again?
Oceanic again.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
I hate the Oceanid. Oceanid, right? Where are you all the way?
Oh, I was climbing up a mountain, so I didn't have to. I needed to get up first before I can change the character.
Oh. Okay. I mean, you could just teleport elsewhere.
Yeah, I know.
As long as you stick to your own path.
But I wanted to switch characters first before I teleport.
Yeah, that's right.
See, oh yeah, I heard Paimon's voice gets lighter the more you go into the story. Is that true?
I didn't notice.
Like, yeah, I don't notice either, but if it progressively gets lighter, we're definitely not gonna notice it until we hear, like, an older recording of Paimon. But I don't think it's changed.
I think there's a recording on YouTube, but I haven't watched it.
Yeah, people are saying, you know, that her voice has gotten lighter ever since release.
You know the event where you get Fischl for free? Her voice is noticeably not Paimon. Like, not squeaky. Or not too high. Or energetic. Mm. So, I guess that's what you mean? I don't know.
It's not what I mean. I mean, I hear people say it. I haven't noticed it myself.
Yeah, same.
Oh, so if TJ's the one that goes here, the weather changes. Understand? Naruhodo.
Naruhodo.
She's the only one who can start the challenge.
Yeah, or a
fool. You know, they used to have this just automatic the moment you enter.
Yeah. Like, we were recording Genshin for RP class. I hate these birds so much. But we were recording Genshin for RP class, and then Garrett accidentally went into this, or me or Garrett, like, accidentally went into was added like earlier before the actual person was most like who was running the world. So we had to hold off while the other two people went to was added.
Let's go!
Retribution! So, heals. Is that the one that explodes?
I didn't iframe it.
I'm kind of curious what the rationale is behind a cryo being effective against Electro. I can see it, but I wonder what
the Fatui one. Are.
Yeah, I'm wondering what, like, the specific reasoning is, like, in logic.
Yeah, same.
The power of water is its ability to
pretty curious.
Yeah. Oh, hold on. No, run away!
I'll take the reins. Let's go, 13k damage. Let's go, big damage.
Let's go.
One who is ignorant of water's treasures fails also to comprehend.
I guess it's 100.
Oh no, I fell off.
That's fine.
Oh no, it's Mr. Krabs!
Bro. Is this the last one?
I think it is.
Okay.
When you Mr. Krabs! Mr. Krabs Wallet! Alright, now feeling it now, Mr.
Krabs. I'm dying.
Oh no! No!
Bruh.
Are you healing? There we go.
Let's see what happens when you lose your foothold.
Ooh, dude, explosion now!
I'm alive. I'm living on a prayer.
I need something to hit so I can heal you. Yeah, I'm almost at my ult. I just need like a few seconds with the Eon.
Is this ability to take any shape?
Always says this.
Oh, it's the bird again. Okay. I'm dead.
Oh,
I just popped off the ult, come on.
It was too late.
Me with the auto food.
I don't have the auto food. Listen.
Watch that reputation.
It doesn't. No, Barbara! Ah!
Oh no, Barbara! The official's almost dead too.
I'm the only healer. I'm perfect. No, no!
I'm on my way, guys. Put up! Ooh.
Yeah. I hate Ultra having to. No! No!
You died!
I still died!
How did you die?
How did you die?
The blast got me even though I was already in the water!
I should have just iframed with my ult. Diluc has a very low energy cost anyways. That's why his damage is so high. Oh, that was pretty fun.
Yeah. 6,000.
See that? Wow, you see that? How could you not say this feeling is good? How? Tell me how. And how much seconds do you have left on your clock?
Huh? It's gonna be up already.
See?
I need three more of
these.
See,
look at this. Look at this. Look at that. It's up again.
Nice. Hey, Jen, how much time do we have left on the recording?
We have 3 minutes.
Okay, I guess we can wrap it up now.
Yeah, we can just wrap it
up. Thanks for the update.
I just want to make it clear. Don't say Kokobi is worse than Barbara. Got it? Got it.
The meta is smolding right now.
I better be. Like, it's unjustified.
Oh, man. But yeah, thanks guys for helping with the question.
Yeah.
Maybe next time me and Jin will be the same world level again. We can go to his.
Nice.
Wait, hold on. What, we can also get to Zarya's world level 2.
What is holding visuals in E-view?
You can keep repositioning.
Yeah.
No, I mean holding it down the first time.
Does it even say there's a tooltip for that?
I don't know. I just hold it down and then something appears on screen. I think I'm supposed to move it. I don't know.
Wait, I'm gonna.
Yeah, like this. See? I have no idea what this is. Oh, it's just a reposition. But I can't even move it further away. I'm just rotating around with
that pose. Look at Rachel right now while she's moving that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hold to adjust location. Oz will be summoned too. Allow me. Wait, what's the pose? Sorry.
When Virgil was like placing Oz under the field.
Do it.
Hold on, my E's are recovering. There's a cooldown, of course. I already used that. It's a skill. Look.
Oh my god.
Zarya. Point at me. And then take a screenshot of it. He's a Spider-Man.
Oh wait, I gotta get it photoed.
I ran out.
It's okay. Just go back. Just go.
No rest. For we gotta wait for Oz to. No rest for the week. In the JoJo post. Wait, you stopped recording, alright?
No.
Oh.
I guess I'll wrap it up now. Thanks for watching, everybody!
Yeah, let's go!
Later.
Okay, so for our next segment, we're now trying something different. Since we've been getting a lot of fan recommendations, like friends telling us to watch certain anime or check out certain manga, games, etc., we've decided to go and tackle these during our fan challenges or fan questions segment before. So now it's going to be fan recommendations. And for our very first one, we have a great anime that has been repeatedly mentioned by some of our friends, such a shout out to Ethan Tamundong and Garrett Escalona for always watch PP or I will sell your kidney. We are going to be watching BB Fluorite Eyes Song. So we all watched at least the first episode.
Yeah.
I couldn't stop.
Both of you guys couldn't stop.
Couldn't stop. Yeah, we couldn't stop.
I didn't even keep watching.
I only watched like the first ep like earlier. So I didn't know you guys were like binging it already.
we watched the second episode last night.
Honestly, I would have binged it too if we weren't like just watching it for the podcast. Like I would have too, like I don't know, like right after have to record. Yeah,
I was like, never mind watching.
Yeah, dude. And then earlier today when we were waiting, you're like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, setting up. You guys watched another episode.
So basically, VV Fluorite Ice Song, let's just call it VV so it's faster. It's set in a really futuristic world where a lot of AI, there are a lot of AI already, super realistic, humanoid, and it starts out like really, really gory and into it, where the AIs are taking over the world, they're killing the humans, and yeah, and stuff. So what we see at the start is there's this scientist guy who starts trying to escape them and only and reaching running towards his lab and then starting to code something and going like, Diva, everything's on you, sorry, and I know you won't want this, but yeah. So he dies. As he dies, he presses enter, and what this basically does is he sent a AI program called Matsumoto back 100 years ago to like before any of the bad AI uprising stuff started. AIs already existed, so that's where we get to see who Diva is, which is the blue haired AI called Vivi by a friend. So she is basically, all of the AI are basically created and only able to do one thing. That's what we're shown. So for example, we were trying to see a caretaker AI work on the PC and take care of a baby. Then she continued typing on the baby. So it seems they are unable to fulfill anything except a single mission. So Vivi's mission is to sing with all her heart and bring joy to people. So that's what she is. She's a songstress AI. And we see at the start that when she's performing, not many people come to see her. And the people who come to see her are like, it's kind of, something's wrong with performance. It's like her voice is good, but something's off, stuff like that. And her biggest fan would be a little girl who gives her this teddy bear thing. Then when the little girl, when she sees the little girl off, she goes back to the stage because she's supposed to perform, but then she like gets invaded by the code that was sent back 100 years. And this code's called Matsumoto, and it basically tells her the two of us are going to save world, like we're going to prevent that whole AI massacring humankind in the future. And she basically doesn't believe it, but that's pretty much the synopsis of the story. They're supposed to save the world after like their 100-year-long journey. They're supposed to save the world and prevent that violent war from breaking out.
Yeah,
man, I love this anime.
True.
One thing I want to note immediately is I really like the close-ups, because like we'll do a close-up on any of the AI and they'll show like how, it really shows just how, because when you're looking at them normally, like in the normal art style, right, except for like some of the AI who look obviously look more robotic, they just look like people. But when you move close up, you can start to notice how mistake they are from a real person, because they're really good at showing the detail of like, oh, it's synthetic skin, synthetic eyes and stuff like that.
Oh yeah, you can show the picture I sent. Yeah, for that,
right. Let me grab that image. Did you have like an opening question you wanted to ask us before we started discussing?
No, it's okay.
I was really excited about this when I like heard stuff from like Garrett Newton, right? And
yeah,
I was like, and like out of the stuff that they kept like recommending us, I think this might have been the one that I was like, really, you know what, yeah, I think I'd definitely check this one out, just because it's time travel and it's also about AI and robots, and I'm really into that stuff. And watching the anime, I was like getting a lot of like I didn't want to word it in a weird way, but like I was like, elements of it reminded me of like the Mega Man series, and like how in Mega Man X, X is the Mega Man of that game was like X is like he's one of the first like truly autonomous like, you know, like robots, right, and stuff like that. And
okay.
Like we have a similar situation with Vivi, who's like the first autonomous AI, and that was like really cool.
Yeah.
That in I get to watch another series like tackle these types of like issues about like AI, what rights do they have, how would they function in society and stuff like that. And I, it's always like such a cool thing for me, and I've always been an advocate of like, you know, AI should be treated like another person. As like, if you make something smart enough that it can be self-aware, it's already a person at that point. So like, it has to have human rights and stuff like that, and that, you know, they should be treated equally. And I thought it was really cool how they also dealt with concepts like, oh, how do we train AI? Like, you know, do we just make the AI? Is it born? Is it considered like, you know, fit for, I don't know, living in society or work already at that point, or do they need to go through a training process and stuff like that. So I was really happy to see like them doing the training, the AI and stuff like that, because they did like a similar thing for X in Mega Man X, where like X was locked up in a pod for like I guess you could say it's like his infancy or something, and for how many numbers of years he was locked in there, going through like training, being taught about life, human society and stuff like that, you know, right from wrong. And I thought it was really cool to see similar concepts here as well, where, you know, AI are trained to do what they, you know, their mission and stuff like that. And it's so interesting just to see the technology and how they represent this change, you know, in, during the 100-year gap and things like that. I'm really interested to see like, you know, how that develops. And when it got to like the point where it was like, oh, that guy, he's like a politician or something, he's trying to pass like a rights law for AI, and I'm like, oh, that's a big turning point that he just suddenly sent her on.
Yeah,
I'm excited to see where that goes.
Yeah, dude.
Well, I'll continue after like hearing you guys' thoughts. Right? I'm trying to remember other things I wanted to point out about that.
Okay, okay.
Vivi, pretty.
This is for you.
He's really pretty, guys.
Here's a detailed close up of her
eye. I'm loved. I'm loved.
I like is the attention to detail. Like, okay, every time the AI have some sort of emergency or some message, the button on their neck, it starts like glowing red and it's like flickering, and then on really important parts when they close up on Vivi, it becomes like really detailed. Yeah, and then I like also the attention to detail that since Matsumoto decided to take the form of a teddy bear, right? They make him squeaky.
Yeah.
When he does something, he squeaks. And I think it's really cute.
I also like how, because here's the thing, when people write robots or AI for media, right?
Yeah.
Most of the time, they're not actually written like how a robot or an AI would act or behave. And I really liked how, you know, Vivi is the first autonomous AI, so, you know, we're not quite there yet. She's still learning what it's like to
converse
naturally and stuff like that. And, like, for example, one other good, like, really well-written AI in media is Baymax. Baymax, the entire movie, never does anything outside of his programming. Any response he gives, it's part of a pre-programmed list of stuff that he's gonna say, and, you know, whatever the AI in him, like, you know, figures out to say in an appropriate situation.
Yeah,
everything he does is makes sense and it's logical, and it's stuff that, you know, would have been programmed by Tadashi, right? And same thing with Vivi, like stuff like she says. So she, it's not like, what often happens is robots and other AI get written like they're on the spectrum. I think that's like how people usually describe it, where like they're socially inept or have or act in a way that, you know, a human would act if they didn't understand how convey certain emotions and stuff like that. Well, that's, you know, a close approximation. It's not exactly how a robot or an AI would behave. So when she says stuff like when her friend like asked obviously, you know, a rhetorical question, you know, like, do you remember when blah blah blah, you know, when we first met?
Yeah, and
like,
then she answered.
Yeah, you know, that was
it was like six months.
And I thought that's really cool that they also pay attention to that kind of detail, and how Matsumoto is obviously from 100 years later is a bit more natural in how he acts.
Yeah.
Right? You can show the difference in how far AI has gotten, where like the AI is almost indistinguishable now from, or you know, already indistinguishable from human. Honestly, Vivi's already at close to that point. She just has to work on her social skills.
Yeah.
I mean,
Matsumoto,
like...
Matsumoto, though. Freaking machine gun mouse right there. Talks 100 words a second.
I like it, though.
Same.
Yeah, I like it.
As soon as she started talking,
that
I was like, yeah,
but... track on the subtitles.
Oh, the subtitles. Like... Honestly, I didn't really... Kidding. How fast were the subtitles going on your end? Because on my end, they like, flicker
They're
out.
Really
they
were really fast. They're fast.
I was able to keep up with them. I was like, yeah, I'm gonna
be top. Just watch the dub with Max Middleman.
Yeah!
Oh my god! So...
My god, Marinette Dupin Cheng.
Before we started recording, Zaria looked at looking for like the video, right? For, so I could add it here. And then Zaria found the cast, the English trailer. And bruh, Zaria, oh my gosh.
My name is Vivi. And I'm just a normal android with one mission. But I have a secret. There's nobody Miraculous!
Miraculous!
Simply the best! Oh my god. Honestly, I think we should also look at the dub sometimes. Like, just see the cast list, see who it is. Like, whenever we
yeah.
do an anime, just to, talk about, like...
To be fair, on the English trailer, it still sounded good.
It does, yeah.
Really I just wasn't expecting it to be Marinette Lupin
Cheng. I also didn't expect it. Like, when I thought about it and, like, how, you know, Christina V's voice sounds like, and I'm like, yeah, I can hear why they choose her for that. But I was like... you know, because like of the roles we know her from, like in Genshin Impact and Miraculous Ladybug, she's voicing this character. She's great. She's great as Vivi. I think her voice fits well.
Yeah.
And but
you know who else
I need...
fits?
Max Middleman is.
Yeah. Max Middleman.
Oh my gosh, I really want to hear him. I don't really want to hear him in the show now. He's
really
huge.
Let's watch them now.
His voice is actually fitting for Matsumoto. Not gonna lie.
Honestly,
wait a minute. Matsumoto.
Another similar
Sakamoto.
Diba, right?
Another
moto.
Moto.
Oh no!
Sakamoto Kuno. Honestly, if Roger Craig-Smith didn't come back as Sonic, I would have loved Max Middleman to be the next Sonic. He fit well then.
Oh, actually, yeah, he was fit.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, back to Vivi. Good anime. Anime good. High
it's
quality.
Really good, yeah.
I only know this because I watched past the first episode, but I think they only sing they only have the opening song on like episode 3. And I think it's nice that because it seems like the singer of the opening song is really Vivi.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, it's the same voice.
It probably is also for the English dub.
The performance.
Because when you sent the trailer for the English dub, I believe it was singing what I think is the opening also. And I heard Christina V's voice. And, you know, of course, she's a singer.
I didn't hear it. I just skimmed through it. I'm going to listen again later.
I'm pretty sure she's singing it. Because both the English and the Japanese
That's
one.
Awesome.
Like the opening part, Vivi's like singing something, right?
And yeah,
you can clearly hear that it was re-recorded in the English dub too, because it's not the Japanese singer's voice coming on; it's Christina V's voice.
It's good though, because that makes it flow like way better. Because she is a songstress, and she really would end up singing eventually.
Yeah, it's great that they got Christina V, because Christina V is really good at singing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh man. What else about the anime? I wanted to talk a bit more about the AI stuff because all of us in the podcast are programmers.
Hell yeah!
I was like, when the AI, you mentioned it earlier about the caretaker thing, right? The caretaker AI. When it was like the tapping on the edge of the crib, I was like, yeah, I know that feeling. When the AI starts doing things you didn't want. Like I was programming an AI for a game, right? So, three enemy types are sharing one base AI class, so they all have the same movements and stuff. And I just switch things around, so like one of them patrols, the other one doesn't, the other one just stays in place, and then I just switch things around with their classes. And oh my gosh, it was so confusing because sometimes every now and then, one of them would start doing behavioral patterns that the other one was supposed to do. Or like one of them who's supposed to stand still won't stop turning around or something like that. And I'm like, yeah, I know that feel whenever like an AI malfunctioned in me.
Oh no, TJ, it's gonna happen.
Oh, I really like the sound design, Ren. Oh my god.
When, yeah. Oh yeah.
When Bibi's running, she obviously sounds like, you know, you can feel the weight of her step.
Like there's a bit of clanking, you know. Yeah. It's not from the shoes. It's like from the.
It's from her body. Yeah. Mm. I really like that attention detail. Yeah, it's nice.
What is the purple juice doing? Is that like her?
I don't know if they showed it yet, but the blue blood for AI is pretty interesting.
It's in the trailer.
Yeah, it's in the trailer.
Mhm. Yeah. What about?
I just think it's interesting.
Yeah, I was like, I'm wondering what that is. Yeah, like why it's there, you know? Mm-hmm. It could be like
a fuel or something.
Yeah,
I'm
like gasoline or something.
That's honestly what they usually do for robots. Like when they get injured, their fuel source comes out. But I think maybe it also could, like, I don't know if I mean they probably don't even really need to explain that. You know, it's a robot. It's not gonna bleed blood. It's gonna bleed whatever's inside, right? But I mean, oh wait, sorry, Android. No, sorry, BB's an Android because she looks like a human. But I mean, like, I just thought it was I'm trying to think of like other like rationales for why she could be having that. And I'm like, oh, maybe it's like a cooling system or something. Like she's hydro cooled or something.
Oh yeah, that could be.
Because humans have a similar system too. But we perspire when we do a lot of heat, and you know our body fluids keep us cool.
Yeah. I mean, like, they didn't really delve into the creation of AI, but then we had the scene, I think, where we saw the limbs getting filled with the fluid and stuff.
Oh, there was?
I think there was a short scene somewhere. I think it was modeled somewhere in the start. They had a short scene where there was a AI being made and, like, they were literally flat. They just had a head. And then, like, the limbs... Like they got their shape because of the fluid getting poured in.
Okay. Oh, it could be. So hydraulics uses hydraulics. You can use liquid for hydraulics as well. So maybe it's like how their bodies move. So
yeah, maybe
to replicate like natural body movements, they use fluids inside the bodies because that's enough. I believe some creatures do that. Yeah. Like some people in. This is getting like really technical, but like, it's simple to discuss because like some people in Spec Evo community, they propose like, oh, some creatures could be hydraulic based, and instead of like having muscles that push and pull limbs, instead they just inflate and deflate like sacks of like water inside their bodies or something, and then it moves the limbs and stuff like that. Like even regular hydraulics also. Yeah, I mean that's how hydraulics works. But yeah, I'm like, yeah, that could be, you know, maybe that's how their bodies work. If they take shape because of like the liquid and stuff like that, maybe their bodies work with hydraulics and stuff like that.
Yeah, that maybe
could. Yeah, could be.
I also really like how Bibi's, hold on, this is going back to like how she was running earlier, right? And like even how she's running, it reminded me of the scene in the RoboCop reboot where like RoboCop's like running, and it's like, ooh, it's clearly an animated like run, guys. It's not like a natural like gait. This is like some stiffness to it, and I really like that attention to detail.
Yeah.
It's also sometimes where like she's talking to someone and then she responds inappropriately because she misinterpreted what they said.
Oh yeah, I also really like that touch because like an AI would have to auto guess about what you're trying to say.
Yeah.
Like and then like, I really like that because like. It also works as a natural like, oh, I messed, you know, because people do that too. But when she says it, it's like, yeah, an AI would do that, but obviously an AI would do that, and I really like that they did that here.
Yeah, really good anime overall. Really high quality animation, high quality sound design, high quality everything.
Yeah, looking forward to more.
Yeah, did.
Recommendation.
Please put it on Netflix, though. I would like to support you.
Netflix. That's weird. Oh, I really, yeah, I really don't like when Netflix like puts in the next season of the anime and then removes the first one.
They
oh my god.
Yeah, like especially if it's an anime that I watched most of it and then I wanted to leave the last episode and the last two for like when I'm not busy so I can really enjoy it. And then they put out the second season. I'm like, yeah, and then I go back and then the last two episodes are
it's gone. Oh no.
Like, why?
Good.
You're awful, Netflix.
You're awful.
You removed this the first season to make fun of me.
I'm awful. How am I awful? That's why I watch on Muse Asia on YouTube.com.
I guess with how this first fan recommendation went, I'm excited to do more.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
I'm excited to hear from our very cultured, exquisite taste friend.
Hey, wait. I know the next one. I'm kidding. I know the one that I was also interested in seeing, so maybe.
I'm hoping like some of the stuff like also crosses with like stuff I already have on my list so that I can get started on some of the things. Because I have a long list and a few of these are actually recommendations from Garrett. Like I have Kumo Desuga Nanika on here, you need the spider isekai. So
To Your Eternity, come on.
To Your Eternity. Hold on, what is To Your Eternity? Because I keep like that short like on my YouTube. I'm subscribed to some reaction channels, right? And like only the ones, of course, that actually talk and discuss about the anime when they watch. I don't want you know those. But and like it starts popping up like on a lot of different people, like who are the watch anime and they're talking about it.
I personally haven't watched it, so I'm just going off of the synopsis because I saw it and I thought it was interesting.
Sure.
What I remember when I read it was that Your Eternity is basically about this thing that is immortal. It can't die. And like it wants to basically understand what it means to live and like why humans like want to live and stuff. So it can take the form of things that have died already. So I think there's this kid or something who takes care of it when it's injured, and then but then the kid is starts to die because he's sick or something. So when the kid dies, he takes the kid's form and like lives on as the kid and tries to understand humankind and stuff. That's basically how I understood it somewhat. It's something like that.
Got it. Man, I'm excited for more fan recommendations. Watching like two episodes like of a different anime like really helps me narrow down the stuff I actually want to watch.
Yeah, because when you watch the first ep, you could be like, this is not my cup of tea, or yeah, I want to watch.
No, fortunately, we haven't had like a bad anime ever since. You know,
do you want?
Then I'm just kidding. No, because when. Before this whole thing became a podcast, me and Julia recorded like three episodes, right?
Data episodes, yeah. There was one.
Our second recording. So the first one we watched was Fire Force, right, for the first ep, and then the second one was the second beta episode had an isekai, and like we both hated it so much.
Yeah.
What was the second one?
I can't remember it, but it was super generic and it was so bad.
Isekai cheat magician.
Oh yeah, I didn't like that.
And then
I really didn't like that.
Yeah.
But yeah, honestly, I know we've been picking a lot of bangers recently, so I really like that.
Yeah.
Any other comments on the episode?
One day we're gonna watch Miraculous Lady.
Oh my god.
Oh, but what? Wait. Hold on.
I honestly have a huge discussion I want on you and me have
watched Miraculous Ladybug, right? But Gian hasn't. So I want us to decide which episode we're gonna have him watch. Because the first season is not chronological at all, right? So I want to discuss with you which episode we're gonna show Gian as the first episode. Because he can really watch
it. I've already been making him watch some.
Oh, you have? Yeah. Nice. Yeah.
Actually, I was really bad because the first one I made him watch was Pina.
What? No! Oh! Cringe episode.
Cringe episode.
Any episode with Lila is instantly cringe.
based
opinions.
but yeah, on a future podcast, I hope that we all have watched Miraculous Ladybug up to season 3 at least. Oh no! And then we have a detailed discussion on something I want to talk about.
Same! I want to rant about Miraculous Ladybug as well.
Okay, I guess I'm gonna be forced to watch.
What we could do Let's go. You guys wanna do a watch party?
Yeah, every now and again.
Yeah, let's go.
Every now and again. Yeah.
Yeah, it'd be fun to rewatch because I'm pretty sure I only have like a few episodes I didn't watch of season 3. So I'm because of the horrible watch order list. It's so messy. It's so messy. There's like several watch order lists for Miraculous Ladybug.
Speaking from experience, because I'm someone who watched both season 3 and still watching season 4 in the order that they release it, which is not the production order, by the way. It's not the chronological order of these events.
Diba?
It can get really confusing.
It was so bad. Because they have one episode where two people have a Miraculous that they supposed to get in a previous episode, but those episodes happen much later.
Yeah, that also kind of happens in season 4 because the first episode they released was episode 7.
Why?
In episode 7 there were a few things that made no sense, but we just rolled with it, and then it made sense after like a few months when they released episode 1 or something.
Bro,
no, when they released episode 4,
what is,
I think
what is
four, yeah.
These two.
It was all over. Yeah,
I'm excited.
The thing is, there's Disney, there's Netflix, and there's this thing called Gloob, I think. And they all release different episodes in different orders. That's why it gets so confusing.
Oh man.
Man, that's...
That sucks.
Yeah.
But I am excited.
But I think any crumbs, I need to know.
Since you brought it up, we're having one episode this season of Off Battle where it's just Miraculous.
Everything Miraculous.
Everything Miraculous. We're all in costumes. We can talk about the show. And our anime review is just gonna be basically a retrospective on the current state of Miraculous Ladybug.
Hell yeah.
You down for that, Gian?
Yeah, I'm down for it.
Oh yeah, let's go. But okay. I think we should wrap it up there for this episode.
Yeah.
We've got some future plans. We've done our fan recommendation. Really excited for more. Any other things you wanna say before we leave off this?
Nah.
Maybe good. Akatsuki no Yona, good.
Good.
Siwon, cringe. No, just kidding.
Siwon,
Lila, cringe.
Lila, cringe.
Lila, cringe.
Lila, cringe.
Siwon, hot.
Okay, fine. I'm okay with him. but I want the main one to be hot.
It's kind of really political. That's why.
Very political.
Yeah.
Both of them are very political, honestly.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So that was several hours.
That was like 2 hours. It was about 2 hours, guys.
2 hours again.
Let's go.
Alright.
Let's go.
See you guys next time. Woo!
Doodly do.